The ice cream man, remember he would come to town and everybody would lose their fucking mind? You couldn't hear your mother calling you, but you hear that ice cream man 3 blocks away. And no matter what you was doing, the shit stopped when Mr. Softy came to town. You be playing marbles and shit,
we ready to roll?
Broadcasting live from the internet, it's Tuesday night, and this is the Panels on Pages podcast.
Big boys playing with big toys.
This is quality content.
The boomers are into it.
Hey, man, I just show up.
With your host, Lee Rodriguez.
I am a visionary. Like, oh, you have a podcast? I'm like, no, that's not me. That's somebody else.
Jason Nyes.
Yeah, sure. I'm not getting any vegetables in my diet. I'm just a thick boy.
Jose Guzman.
Is Jose on the show tonight?
He says he's coming.
It's like Elton John all over again, just minus the death threats.
Kelly Harris.
Reach your hand in your pants there, big boy.
That's not me. I don't sound like that anymore.
And our good buddy Mahoney.
Hey, Mahoney's here. What's up, Mahoney?
We can do just glorious, wonderful things on our phones, people.
No one's ever done either of this before.
It's going to be massive.
It's going to be great. I mean, obviously, I think it'll be great.
It's all killer, no filler.
My seat's on fire. Your take's so hot.
Come on.
It's so good. It's pretty good. It's there. It's reliable. You know what you're getting every single time.
Man, I'm so glad you found us.
You're all terrible people, and I'm glad you're my friend.
But that's the intro.
That's really funny.
Over 500 episodes. And you'd think they'd have the hang of it by now.
It seems like the concept that would run its course very quickly. What is going on, everybody? Today is Tuesday, May 18th, 2021. And this is episode number 558 of the Panels on Pages podcast. I am your host, the Lord Reverend Lee Rodriguez. Joining me tonight, we have Mr. Jason Nyes.
No, Lee, that's my slave name.
I'm waiting for that one. I knew it this time. I knew it. Jose Guzman.
Fruity Pebbles, but it's Lucky Charms.
Kelly Harris.
Who keeps telling Tony Storm to wear pants?
Oh, and our good buddy Mahoney. What's up, Mahoney?
Tony Stark, Kelly. It's Tony Stark.
And that's not
pants.
He
can wear all the pants he wants. That's... I don't care.
You're confusing Tony Stark with Tony and Storm of the X-Men.
Mm.
Mm-mm. Those are two very different people.
I saw a guy this weekend that had a killer fucking Storm tattoo. He had a Storm on his upper arm and Black Panther on his lower arm. It was badass. Looked great.
I don't believe it.
And then we bought an iPhone from him.
Was this a black
that
man?
I believe.
What's that?
Was this a man at like a store, or were you just like in a parking lot?
Yeah, he was like, hey man, you want an iPhone? I'm like, yeah, what you got? Three tattoos, by the way.
Was this a black man?
Very.
Okay, good, yes, good, good.
Very. Oh yeah, it'd be real weird otherwise.
Yeah.
That'd be an odd theme, you know? Yeah. I'm like, why is that good, good? Oh, that's why it's good, good. Right. Yeah, no, that is good, good, as a matter of fact. Yeah. Yeah, no, it's good. We bought a new phone for the young girl because she's got her graduation coming up. So that's pretty cool. So you know, it's a big deal.
Whoa! She's about to graduate high school.
Oh God, I'm turning to dust.
No, it's fucking
middle school.
Grade graduation is a thing here now.
Yeah.
Apparently, it wasn't when I was a kid. Like, I don't remember ever doing this, but like, it's so insane to me because like, it just like.
Just going
celebrating
back
mediocrity is an eighth grade graduation. What the fuck are you doing? Like, this is nothing. It's a nothing event. But apparently, I'm the asshole for thinking that. And everyone else thinks it's a big deal and, you know, cool.
Yeah, it's big swap to a new school.
Tennessee is a big, like, red state. Aren't they, like, the non-participation trophy type people? What is this eighth grade graduation poor shit?
Yeah, right. Exactly. You know, fucking. I thought you had to pull yourself up by your bootstraps and all that bullshit, but. Apparently, we can celebrate graduating eighth grade. Okay.
I don't know. I feel like Tennessee eventually was like, we might want to just take our wins where we can get them.
Yeah.
They're like, this is our college.
Yeah, like we've run the numbers. And turns out
we can wait until high school is over, but honestly, like, a lot more successful if we just do it after 8th grade.
Just, you know, we're talking purely numbers here. Purely numbers. I think we should go 8th grade. But it's cool. So that's all done and taken care of. It's fine. Just... oh. I'm so fucking tired of this deck thing, you guys. I'm so tired of building a fucking deck in the backyard.
Ridiculous. No, you love building a deck so much. You're like, let me put a deck on my roof, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, the roof. I gotta tell you, these guys took care of that roof in no time. It was insane. But here's the thing about the deck. The deck is fine. The deck is coming along wonderfully. You know, we hired a buddy of mine to do the deck. He said he would do the deck. I told him the
You're taking this Pokemon stuff really seriously.
I told him the day the deck needed to be finished. At no point has it ever appeared, even for a moment, that that wouldn't happen at all. And yet my beautiful wife is just... I wish I had the wherewithal to stick a lump of coal up her asshole 3 weeks ago, because I would have the most beautiful diamond by now.
Happy anniversary.
It's just... She's having such a hard time. She knows she does. She has a very type A personality. She has a very hard time with things that she cannot directly control, and just kind of letting it go and, you know, let the process take on and do its thing. She's had a very tough time with it.
What's the rush? Like, who cares when your deck is finished?
Well
that's easy for you to say, Big Deck Dan.
I mean, you recently built the deck. Like, who cares? It's done when it's done.
Wanted it to be done for Jack's birthday party. Okay, so we have an event, you know, so there is like a reason. So I don't falter for that, but it's
destroy the deck anyways.
Oh, I got some good composite boards that are indestructible. This thing is good. It's a fucking fortress. Like it's solid. It's going to be fine. But, you know, she's just having a hard time just watching it, you know, and like if a couple of days go by and cause, you know, my buddy's got a regular day job too. So he doesn't get out here every day. You know, so if a couple days go by and nothing happens, she just gets all antsy about it. And I'm like, yeah, but we still got 2 weeks. Like, this is almost done, and there's two weeks. You know, like, it's fine.
For lack of a better word, the foundation, like, the structure of it is the hard part. That's the time-consuming part. Screwing the deck boards and the railings on is going to take, like, an afternoon.
Yeah, it's fine, you know.
Yeah, tell Nicole, get on out there.
Yeah, how about you tell her, Kelly?
Tell her Mahoney volunteered to help.
Yeah. I'd have that deck done in no time. We all know that. I've been watching my neighbors build a swing set and just counting the ticking off the days of like, well, I would have been done a week and a half ago. Yep.
Big Deck Dan's going to fly down on Friday night, finish it Saturday afternoon, fly back Sunday morning.
I'm going to fly down. I'm going to finish it. You're going to wake up, be like, oh my God, the deck is done, and I'm already going to be gone. You're never going to know I was there.
It's going to be decorated for a birthday party.
I'm going to have made myself some snacks and done all my own dishes. You're going to be like, this is weird.
The only indication that Mahoney was ever there was Jax tells him that they played Fortnite together.
Yeah, everybody's like, Jax, shut up. That's not real.
You fucking liar.
Yeah.
But like, you know how you do, Jax. Like, yeah, but this time it's real. But at one point, I looked at her the other day, and I'm like, "Are you upset with me for not being more upset?" And she's like, "Yes." I'm like, "Okay, like this is crazy talk." But then she looked at me last night and was like, "If I'm having a hard enough time with this, we never ever could have built a house." And I said, "Oh God, no! I'd have put you in the foundation weeks ago. Like, there's no way that would happen." No, so but it's good because, you know, we're learning a lot about ourselves and our limitations. And hers is construction projects. She just does not do well with them. So I'm really excited about when I decide to build that outbuilding outside. So it's gonna be great.
But, whoa!
Like, for I'm
what sitting, building?
You're building an outhouse?
Like an outbuilding, like a freestanding thing. Gonna put like a building
to poop in
the driveway. It's gonna be dope.
Sugar?
Yeah, no, that's, like a... that's not a phrase I've ever heard.
Oh, really? Yeah, that's a thing, then. Outbuildings are a thing.
You building a snore
box? Not an outhouse, an outbuilding.
He's like, I need a place where I can get naked to shit that's free of judgment.
You take the Sears catalog out there and...
No,
flip put some games through until you find the bras. Seat.
It's going to be cool. It's going to be great.
I got all kinds of games I can play on the shitter.
Yeah, I might just drug her for that one, though. That's fine. It's fine. It's going
to
be great.
But, just, you know, tell her to stick her fist into the Rodriguez pill jar and just whatever happens, happens.
Fucking ridiculous.
Time for an upper, time for a downer. Who knows?
Okay, we're not an upper house. Kelly, come on. Get the fuck out of here with that. That's the last thing we need are uppers around these parts. Ridiculous. But yeah, that's, you know, that's like, for I'm sitting, you know, we should not ever have to talk about it again, the deck, but apparently we have to talk about it every day. I love you, girl. It's going to be fine. It's going to be wonderful. It's going to be worth it. It's got to get through this fucking nightmare.
You're going to be
extra great.
Sunning in that thing in no time. Just wading in the water.
If you want to keep her busy, remind her all the shit she needs to get. Like, she needs chairs, she needs umbrellas, she needs rugs.
Oh, you're talking as if you haven't had two rugs. Amazon boxes. You're talking like you haven't gotten two Amazon boxes a week, a day for the last week.
Like, of course.
And they had the lawn chairs ready. Those are what they sat in until the couch showed up.
Oh, that's right.
That's exactly right, Kelly. The other day, I forget the context, but I was like, hey, remember that time you sold the couch before we had a couch? And we're like, this is a reasonable thing to do. She's like, yeah, I sure do. I'm like, all right, cool.
No regrets.
It worked out
right now, though, guys. It did work out because the couch is super fucking dope.
I don't really remember many complaints.
It was a dark period.
But on the bright side, your new house does not smell like your dog because your dog didn't come to the new house, and neither did your couch that smelled like your dog.
That's right.
Nope, definitely not. I had to kick his old ass off my bed 3 times yesterday. I just walked downstairs to be on my bed like, you fucker, get out of here. He's like, I'm sorry. But not really.
He was like, how about you fucker get out of here?
Yeah. How about you get off my bed? You ever think about that? Nope. All right. Have a good day.
I go lick my balls over here.
That is a dead-on Buster impression. That sounds exactly like him.
Guess I'll just go fuck myself then.
Go chase my tail in the street.
Yeah. Other than that, has a pretty wild Japan shit going on lately at that at Rodriguez house. Pretty good. So, Zoe and I have finished up watching Parasite. I don't know if you've seen that one, Kelly. It's pretty damn good.
The anime?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about
the... Yeah, no, I've never seen that.
Academy Award winner, Parasite.
Yeah.
No. The other one. The other one.
I was like, Kelly put us on to Parasite before anybody was talking about it.
I still haven't seen that because I have to read it.
Oh, you'll never see it.
I don't
know.
It
would take us coming to your house and taking your phone away from you.
Please don't. Don't do that.
Like an afternoon showing of Logan.
But no, so yeah, the premise is suddenly these tiny parasitic creatures start taking over human beings and eating people with their crazy giant monster faces. It's the whole thing.
Okay.
But the main guy, instead of the parasite latching onto his brain as is tradition, it like fucks up and just like possesses his right hand. So he ends up with like, you know, being super strong, and everybody also has this creature that lives in his hand and like can morph into weapons and shit like that. Like you know, his hand will just turn into like a blob with a couple of eyeballs and a human mouth on it and talk to him and shit. It's very strange.
Just like Venom.
Kind of. But it's just
really does it make him breakfast?
This is literally
and sing
the
a song?
Story of Venom. Is it like lobster?
Yeah,
but
lobster,
it does yeah, but it does, you know, flop around and just it's really gross. But it's a good time. We enjoyed that. Highly recommended it. And then we started The Promised Neverland after that. I don't know if you've seen that one, Kelly, but it's
I will warn you, that series, I haven't watched it. I read the manga. Apparently the anime drops off real hard in season 2.
Really?
To the point where our sales on that manga have jumped huge because people hated the anime
because
so
the
much
show is they, so bad.
They started picking up the manga to see how the series actually went. Because really? They diverged so heavily from the source material, it got and just tanked it.
Huh.
Yeah, so season 1, good. Season 2, no.
Interesting. Okay. Duly noted.
A great I really like the comics a lot.
I'll keep that in mind, because right now it's not in English anywhere. There's no dub for the second season yet. Sorry, I'll keep that in mind. You know, tell the kid to start reading some shit. Which, to be fair, she likes reading that kind of stuff.
She'd probably like that series a lot.
Kid's been burning through all my Junji Ito stuff. I'm like, yeah, girl, get it.
Oh, hell yeah. Then, definitely get her on Promised Neverland. So how far
into that, mixed up, guys? And have her watch, was it Leaving Neverland?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yikes.
Hey there, little guy.
Completely different
manga.
Manga.
Like, Dad, Kelly was right. The second season of this show is super dark, and that's saying something.
I'm going to keep faxing you pages of Akira. Ow!
Wild.
I thought you don't sound that way anymore, Kelly. What just happened? I thought you didn't sound that way.
Oh, I was using my old microphone.
Oh, okay. Okay, cool.
So how far into the Promised Neverland did you guys get?
I don't know. Maybe 4 or 5 episodes.
About where Tito started fucking up. And then Jermaine was like, what the fuck is going on?
It's like the second lady's there, and they're trying to kind of hash their plan or whatever. And it's
Dr. Jill Biden. Wild. Like, that's one, I got to tell you. That's a show where the first episode is over and like, oh, so this is what this is going to be about. All right. It's a hell of a, yeah, so it got a very Shyamalanian ending to the very first episode. So it's pretty wild.
Yeah. That's a good series to go in blind to, because it's just like, oh shit. Okay.
Yeah. That's what I'm not saying a whole lot about it, because I feel like it would kind of ruin it. So you need that moment. So I would highly recommend checking it out if you're of the persuasion.
Yeah. It's good.
Last fucking thing to talk about. I built me a damn Leopardon model, a dumb
Japanese Spider-Man robot, and it's fucking cool.
I need to buy one of those.
Oh, it's so dope. Transforms, comes with all the gimmicks, like all these clear effect parts to make him throw his dumb head crest thing and throw his sword and rocket fists and the whole fucking nine. Even comes with a little tiny car that can go on the back of its head. It's insane.
So I bring it up because I'm building it,
and having a good time with it. And Jax comes over and he's like, what the hell is this? I said, oh, yeah, it's Spider-Man's giant robot from the Japanese TV show. And he's like, get the fuck out of here. What are you talking about? Like, Spider-Man ain't got no giant robot, Dad. I'm like, oh, he had a giant robot in the 1978 live-action Japanese TV series. He's like, show me. So I said, oh, buddy, here we go.
And I fired up this. Dad, what is 1978? What are these numbers?
Right? Dude, I've found this YouTube clip. It's like 7 minutes of just the nonsense that is this show. And it takes a lot for this kid to side-eye me with a, what the fuck are we watching? But he gave me one of those so hard. Like, like one of the parts where the little duck-faced henchmen are running and they do that weird, like it cuts and they do like a backflip and then it cuts again. They do a backflip and it cuts again for no discernible reason. And he's like, why are they doing this? And I said, bro, I don't know. Like, I don't know why anybody's doing anything in this show. It's batshit crazy. And it's over, and I'm like, what'd you think? And he goes, I don't need to see that again. I'm like, that's a fair reaction, son. That is very odd. But it's a fun damn model. Would recommend. It's got the stand platform thing has storage for all the gimmicks, which is pretty cool. Which normally is like a bag of extra parts. Very, very cool. Would recommend. But don't pay $90 for it. It's not worth all that. What you got, Nyes? What's up?
Oh, I'm just going to need all you guys to get on my level, because I finally hit level 200 on Fortnite yesterday, which was pretty cool.
The boyhood dream has come true.
And then
I'm at like 35.
And then, well, Jose, you need to hop on. Jose, you need to hop on and play some squads with us then, so that we can murder a bunch of noobs.
Yeah, really.
Because before the show tonight, Mahoney and I got murdered by someone with a Golden Spire Assassin skin, which we didn't even know existed. Apparently, you get that when you hit level 225. So,
Jesus.
Which, yeah, I gotta say, really makes me want Nyes to have it. Because there was really just this moment of panic when that person was coming at us, and we were like, is that a golden spire guard? What the hell is that? And then we were both dead.
Yeah, I don't...
The god said, why, yes, sir, I am a golden god.
Yeah, I went on a tear the other night and ended up at like level 155 or something. I killed a whole bunch of quests and shit like that. And I did well, but I haven't got that W because I haven't you know, been practicing a whole lot. And it's like when you're at this high, man, like it's just killers.
It's tough. It's just
killers. On solo, oh man, it's nuts. So yeah. Fucking good on you.
Jax jumps on in the afternoon and he's like, look at my dad got me this. My dad got me this. He got me this. He got me, Rebirth, Rachel Roth, Raven. I'm like, yeah, he at least recognizes that his dad does his levels for him now, which I appreciate.
Yeah. Yeah. Cause last time it was like, I got all this by myself. And I'm like, fuck you. You did not.
But I tell you what,
I play in my sleep, I think, because I wake up and I got shit I never even saw before.
It was real tough because at the end of last week, I was at level 195, you know, just I could touch it. I could taste level 200. But then I had to go basically Saturday to Monday morning not playing Fortnite because my in-laws were in town visiting. And oh, boy. That was tough. That was tough going without Fortnite for two whole days. Well, not even two whole days. Maybe 36 hours. Just imagine all the stuff in the shop that I missed.
You should have had them play.
Oh, no. No. Like we talked before, I don't really curse around them. I'm sure they know that I'm not as proper as I act around them. But if I had turned on Fortnite, they would have heard a fuck shit. For sure. So, you know, with guests coming, you know, we did a lot of cleaning. We, improved the house a bunch, which was cool. It's always nice to have people over to force you to stop wallowing in your own filth. So I appreciate that. We need to have people over more often. But basically, we just sat on the couch and watched HGTV on Discovery Plus for a majority of it. It's inoffensive, kind of very vanilla television. We watched a lot of Bahama Life, which is people house hunting for places in the Bahamas. Watched a lot of Flip or Flop, some Love It or List It, some Property Brothers. But then one night, I was able to convince Mary to put an episode of Hoarders on. And it was a particularly gross episode. So the next night when I suggested it, she would not allow it. She did not let that happen right before bed watching Hoarders. But, oh, speaking of, thank you to Kristen Allen for letting us know there was a new season of Hoarders on Netflix to watch that we jumped right into. To the point where we'd watch an episode, and then the next night, Mary would be like, I kind of want to watch a Hoarders. As a guy.
Oh, my God.
And remember, this is Hoarders. Ridiculous. This is not hoarding Buried Alive. So it is the lesser of the Hoarders franchises, but still,
oh my God.
Very good. Very good. It's essentially, God. It's the cast of characters that's different. The therapists, the organizers, the cleanup crews. I prefer the Hoarding Buried Alive teams, but Hoarders still get you that really good, that really juicy mental illness to sink your teeth into.
Oh, my God. Jesus Christ.
Last week...
Up until you talked about the Hoarders, it sounded like you spent a week in a doctor's office waiting room.
Yeah, exactly. just sitting quietly on the couch, just watching HGTV, and every so often we would talk about something, whether it be blinds or the traffic in Atlanta. I don't know, you know, nothing too controversial. Was it Thursday?
Talk about Palestine?
No, no, I won't talk about Palestine with anyone. I do not know enough about that situation to ever try my hand at having a conversation about it. All I know is it's going to fuck things up for all of us in the end somewhere. So the Thursday, the CDC came out and said, hey, if you're vaccinated, you don't got to wear a mask anymore. And it's kind of like, all right, cool. I like this idea. So we had plans to hit up Target in the grocery store before our guests got here and brought the mask just in case. Because it's like, you know, I want to be safe, but also we can't be wearing masks the rest of our lives. If they say it's cool, if you're vaccinated, then it's cool. Let's give it a shot. We go to Target. They still got the signs up front, and it's come out in the news more recently that they're not getting rid of their mask rules for now. So still wore our masks in Target. Went to the grocery store. Still had the signs outside. Still the same ratio of people to wearing masks, not wearing masks. So fuck it. We wore our masks. But then when the in-laws came, we went to take a walk around our little downtown area here, which, you know, we moved in February of last year, and then COVID hit, so we haven't gotten to explore our little town at all.
I guess not, yeah.
But, you know, so we went for a nice little stroll around our downtown area, masks off. You know, the first time we've really been around a lot of people going into shops. And, you know, even before COVID, I don't like to go into small stores and just get trapped in there. So a lot of it was me just standing outside or sitting on a bench or whatever. And then we hit up this restaurant that Mary's been wanting to go to for forever. Again, not a mask on any face in there, and super small, super claustrophobic. So it was a lot, like, in one day to just kind of be thrust back into the maskless world. But
it's very weird. Like, nobody fucking wears a mask around here but us. Like, we're the extreme minority. So if it is really weird, you know. I'm so used to doing it at this point that I have to kind of remind myself not to. And I'm like, oh, man, a stranger's going to see my chin. I do declare. how scandalous. Oh, my good. Oh, my stars.
So we're coming home from our trip out. And the week before, we've got an extra guest bedroom, but it's pretty bare. It looks like we heard yesterday that we've got a foster kid coming tomorrow, and we're like, oh shit, we gotta put a bedroom together. So like, there's a bed in there and not much else, so we're like, okay, we need
bed and a Michael Jordan poster.
Like, we need something,
and a lava lamp for some reason.
They need like bedside tables to just be able to put their shit on during the night, so that it's not just sitting on the floor. So we went on Amazon and ordered a pair of bedside tables for $100. They were supposed to be here on Thursday. We get the shipping information, and they weren't supposed to get here until Monday, the day that our guests were already supposed to leave. So that's cool.
Well, that'll be useful.
Right. Super useful. So we pull up to the house after our trip out, and there's these two huge boxes sitting on the front porch. And I laugh. I'm like, ha, ha, ha. Our bedside tables are here. Isn't that funny and ironic? I guess I know what I'm doing the rest of the day. I go to grab these large boxes off the porch, and I realize, no, these are not our bedside tables. This is my NECA Ninja Turtles street diorama and my Movie Turtles accessory set. So I laugh, I bring them inside, and I make the comment to Mary, ha ha ha, they're not the bedside tables, they're Ninja Turtles. And my father-in-law says Ninja Turtles with an inflection that makes you think he had never heard those two words said together before in his life.
He said, what?
Ninja
Turtles? They got turtles that are ninjas.
Well, they actually don't have the Ninja Turtles in Ohio. They never got them there.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, in Ohio, they just call them karate chop frogs.
Yeah.
He's like, you mean battle toads, right?
Battle toads?
I was making the
jiu-jitsu geckos.
Biker mice from Mars. They were all about the biker mice from Mars in Ohio.
Yeah.
We were, Mary and I were discussing it earlier. We were kind of laughing it off, and she said, oh, yeah, he's telling somebody, yeah, my son-in-law likes these things called, he collects Ninja Turtles. And I'm like, oh, God, please don't. Please don't talk. Please don't tell anyone about anything about me, please.
Yeah.
It's an interesting thing coming from you, your weird don't necessarily say weird, but like it's just the shell you put up around the in-laws is odd. Like if anything, I'd turn it up.
Shell, because turtle.
Yeah, right.
The story's like, gonna come back.
The story's gonna come back.
No, go ahead.
I don't know who else is gonna talk.
Nah, I was just saying, if anything, I turn it up around my in-laws.
Yeah.
Because I like make them squirm a little bit. And because they're so they're lovely people. Lovely people. But they're just very vanilla. So I like the sprinkles at them when they're around.
I don't know. I think we might need to have an in-law vanilla off just to see.
Oh,
he goes back thinking that you train animals.
Well, at least he's...
What if you gather the in-laws?
Fight each other.
Yeah, you guys gather the in-laws, and then Nyes and Lee just kiss each other on the mouth in front of them and
yes!
see what happens.
Yes!
See who leaves first.
Oh, I would do it in a heartbeat. Yeah. Like a heartbeat.
Yep, same.
All right, guys, we have something to show you.
We might as well bring our dads, too, while we're at it.
Yeah, right.
Oh my god. So the
god, what are you doing next weekend?
the end of my in-law visit story is thus, you know, when I'm stressed or I've got something going on, especially like a convention trip or something like that, I get locked up. Like my body's like, all right, no time for the poopies. You can poop in 3 days when everything's chill. And, you know, aww. I never planned for this to happen, but it seemed like Friday hit and they left on Monday. I didn't shit for 4 days. And to the point where I was like gassy, I would go into the bathroom to be like, all right, yeah, here we go. And just rip a couple echoey farts into the bowl and then it'd be nothing. To the point where, you know, we would go to eat, and I'd be like, I don't know how much more stuff I want to put in here until some of it comes out. You know, maybe I need to take it easy a little bit. They leave Monday morning, and I, pardon the pun, shit you not, I number two'd 5 times on Monday.
Oh, now you're on my level.
Different.
You're on my level now.
Different amounts, different consistencies, different, just a rainbow of different colors. And I'm back, baby. Back to 100%. We got our house back. I can say the F word again. I'm playing Fortnite again. I can rub up on Mary's butt while she's cooking dinner. It's great.
It's hard having people in your house.
It's difficult. You do that all the time,
especially
honey.
People you can't just be yourself around, you know?
I mean, it's not that big of an imposition. I
no,
don't feel like I'm hiding.
It's not nothing.
Yeah, it's not nothing. They're
you
very nice
Fortnite,
people.
You couldn't poop.
Yeah.
Couldn't play with your toys.
Couldn't rub up
but
on
also,
Mary's butt.
Couldn't
that
rub
was for,
on some butt.
That was for 36 couldn't hours night. After not seeing them since September 2019. So I can grit my teeth through it, you know?
Yeah, that's fair.
Well, yeah.
But I'm good now, baby.
I'm just saying. Give yourself the space to feel, you know. That you like to shit more than once every 4 days.
Well,
it's not unreasonable.
Let's also look at the example. You know, we watched one episode of Hoarders, and that was a tiny peek at the true Nyes. And the next night, Mary was like, no, none of that. Keep that bottled up inside.
Put that shit back in the closet.
You should have just had them listen to the podcast, and they would be like, oh, your friends are much worse than you.
What is a pop cast? Yeah. Ninja Turtle?
I could have shown him some Tik Toks.
This one keeps talking about cum.
Oh, God.
Which one?
It could be any
look
of us.
At this
it
picture
on the
of
week.
Sandy Cheeks. Why is she sucking a car into her giant penis?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Jennifer's mom was like, "Did you do Lee's podcast?" And Jennifer's like, "Yeah, and you can't listen."
Oh, that's gonna make her want to watch it, listen to it
more. Rude.
Big cake me, it's okay, Squirrel Dick.
I'm gonna head over to Jennifer's mom's house, and I'm gonna play her the podcast, and you know, have a fine time.
Not sure it would be. Not sure it would be. So what's up, Jose?
Not much. Chilling. No midnight Walmart stories, but.
I remember that.
That was so good.
We started watching this show, Startup. It's, was it? Not Adrian Brody. Who's the other? He was on The League. Adam Brody.
Adam Brody, yes.
Adam Brody. I think he was the bad guy from Legion. He was just in something as a bad guy. I can't remember. No, not that guy. The other dude. Either way. So it's about.
Shout out to no names.
Cryptocurrency. Yeah, shout out. Cryptocurrency, Haitian mob, Russian mob. It Ozark's in Miami, but with the Russians and the Haitians.
All right.
Okay.
What an elevator pitch. Right. They got Dogecoin? They buying Dogecoin on that show?
No. It's GenCoin. Like this girl creates a superior cryptocurrency model. And she's trying to get people to invest legitimately, and it doesn't happen. And for certain reasons, she ends up with money that happens to belong to the Haitian mob. And hijinks ensue. Very good. So far, 3 seasons. We're 2.5 in.
Jesus.
It's a Crackle original.
You guys binge harder than anyone I know. Said.
Well, because we're doing puzzles, so we just put it on, and we end up blowing through like half a season in a day because we're puzzling. We puzzle people, man. We just started a Yoda puzzle. It's pretty badass. That one's going in the frame line. Framing puzzles is cool, but them frames ain't cheap, man.
No.
That fucking frame for that Dolly painting, like low end, we're looking at 70.
Oh my God!
Damn.
Yeah, God.
Wow.
It's one of those because it's not meant to be framed.
Right.
It's a puzzle.
It's not a
standard
size.
So the dimensions are weird. Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck you if you want to frame anything that is not standard size.
All that crafting you do, you got to start making your own frames.
Probably. Yeah. Get some crown molding and fucking 45-degree cut that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. You can get some like plexiglass or even real glass and. Score it, snap it,
flip it, rub it down. Oh my! but highly recommend Startup if you're looking for something to binge while you're puzzling. That and I told you we watched The Bad Batch, so we started on Clone Wars.
There you go. Yep.
Back in from the start, so I think we're on like towards the end of season two, maybe on season three of that already. Those are quick watches. And then we fucking started the prequels. We're going to watch the prequel movies.
Has she ever seen those?
She's seen them, but she saw them when nephews were up age. They enjoyed it, so she enjoyed it. She's got a different prequel experience. But then with watching shit with me, I'm always throwing out critiques and this and that, so she's like she's noticing more. She pointed out earlier, like it was a shot where from the front the guy has the mask on, like it's like dangling from his ears, but then the reverse shot of who he's talking to, the mask isn't even on his face. She's like, before I wouldn't even have noticed. They're two completely different takes, scenes mashed, you know what I mean? Like she sees the cuts and the edits. She's seen how the fudge is made.
So these people are talking to each other on the screen and you're looking at it? It's odd.
Meh, love it.
It's weird. Why don't you just listen to it like a radio play while you're in the shower?
Well, because you can't get the puzzle wet.
Fair, fair.
Okay, okay, $1 million idea. Shower puzzle.
Wet right. puzzles.
I mean,
waterproof puzzles, just like some nice dirt. They got those waterproof playing cards. I'll play spades with you in the shower. You want to take a bubble bath? We got one of those stand-up bathtubs. We fucking throw four of us around.
All right, we're going to invite Nyes and Lee's in-laws, and they're going to watch
watch us Maloney do a tub spades tournament.
Maloney and Jose play spades in the bath.
No, we need two others. Spades is a team game.
Oh, yeah. All right. I mean, I'll be in. All right.
Come on, Kelly. That's don't be saying. Ridiculous.
Yo, Kelly.
You don't know no spades, Kelly?
I don't know anything about spades.
Jose, he's white from Milwaukee.
Yeah.
You know what? The only reason I know spades is because I know you.
Yeah, but I think if you would have lived in Chicago long enough, you would have known what spades was.
I grew up in Naperville, Jose.
Yeah, that's...
Well, yeah, but I'm saying, but if you stayed in Chicago, who knows, like, where do you think you would have ended up?
I would have found the Jose of, like, the outer areas of Naperville. Just looking to piss off my dad.
Yeah. Hose B living in. Hey, there is.
Hose B?
No. There is a legitimate
two-player Jose
Desmond in Chicago.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
My computer twin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You would have met him.
Fucking palette swap Jose.
Shit, you think I'm bad? That dude was skipping out on bail.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
At least I make my court appearances.
Yeah, and you bitch about the chair pictures.
No, I didn't bitch about it. I just said I'm on to their game. Don't be falsifying history and throwing it up in the courthouse like it's fact.
I spent so long trying to find that picture so that I could Photoshop it into like other places. Just like not even say anything. Just like a picture of somebody's house that we're like sharing in the group chat to like be like, look at this nonsense. And just in the background there would be that chair, and Jose would be like, what the fuck? They've got the chair too.
It's like the videos slowly you find where ahead. The 1940s where somebody's on an iPhone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
the chair was in every decade.
Every assassinated president sat on that mm-hmm. chair.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yep. That's the chair Lincoln was sitting in.
That chair was turned into the car seat in JFK's car.
It was the chair Mona Lisa was sitting in when you painted her.
It was the crib of the Lindbergh baby.
I love it.
So that's a thing. Puzzles. Wrapping up some fucking binging. Got some other things.
Always.
Clean the car.
Always got irons in the fire.
Always.
So much fire, about to burn some lava.
Christ. What's up, Kelly?
I went to a movie theater.
Wow.
Hey, all right.
I saw the...
Hold on.
Did you go just for the Venom trailer and then left?
Yeah. Yeah.
Before you go any farther, I just want to stop Juggalo John, who's going to be in the chat, and he's going to be like, I've been seeing movies since COVID started, so I just wanted to get that out of the way. Continue.
Well, don't
Kelly.
Do that.
Yeah.
People shouldn't have been doing that. But I went to go see Spiral because I'm vaccinated and my friend's vaccinated and we're safe.
Damn.
So Spiral's fun. I had never seen Saw prior to Thursday.
I see Saw all the time.
Yep.
No, did you watch Saw before Spiral or after Spiral?
Before.
Okay.
So let's cover Saw first. So. That movie is far more tame than I ever would have thought.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Totally different than you expected, right?
Yeah, because everyone talks about it like it's, oh my god, it's brutal violence, horrible.
Yep.
The sequels go nuts.
Absolutely.
And then also, you also have to look at it through the prism of when it was, where like, even Saw as it is, like by today's standards it's pretty tame, but even back then it was kind of on that level.
Yeah, and
but it's like, I would say like, fucking Reservoir Dogs is way worse than that.
Yeah,
they caught shit for Reservoir Dogs.
I don't know.
You'll see a big difference.
I don't know, man. That one trap where it's like the razor wire mouse maze, where the dude just bleeds out trying to go through all the barbed wire. That's pretty fucked. That's like up there with one of the seven murders.
Yeah. I don't know, I just felt like you didn't see a ton. It wasn't like horribly graphically violent to me.
You're right, though. Those guys can't catch for shit.
They can't catch for shit. They're constantly throwing shit to each other, and no one catches a single thing in the entire movie. And it's all whatever they're throwing is always flying past them, and then they have to dig through a pile of like broken tiles or whatever. And
you think Cary Elwes at some point be like, "Just slide it, just slide it." Yeah.
And then I had just, as I was scrolling through Twitter, and I saw this good tweet about the first Saw movie. And it says,
yes.
I need to bring it up.
Okay, I need to bring it up. This is the one you just shared with us?
Yes.
Okay. I'm on it.
All right. Because, yeah, this is something I never would have noticed. I mean, who's looking for something like this in this movie from 2001? So the tweet comes from @MurderWizard.
Oh my god!
And it says, "Feel bad for the guys in Saw, because tomorrow's gonna be a bummer too." And it shows a close-up of the cell phone they have, and the date reads September 10th, 2001.
Oh no! Oh no!
And they look so happy.
Oh, well, the interesting part about that is, like, most of the Saw movies take place on September 10th, 2001.
Yeah, or the 11th. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's wild. But yeah, so that movie was decent enough. And then, so Saturday, I saw Spiral. I like that movie a lot. Nice. Like, it's pretty fun. It reminds me a lot of that first one. It feels much more like a mystery movie than it does like a torture porn movie.
Well, good. I hope they get back to that. Like, that's, I don't need a torture porn. Like, there's plenty of that.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Good mysteries are hard to come by.
That became the thing. Everybody wanted to fucking beat it off to some torture.
Yeah. Like, it feels more than anything to me like a throwback 80s cop movie. Like, Chris Rock is the renegade cop on the force. Can't trust anybody else because they're all corrupt. And then he's got to go saw the Saw.
That sounds pretty dope.
Yeah, it's pretty rad. He's great. Chris Rock is awesome. The movie starts with him just like ripping Forrest Gump a new one. So that's fun.
So the original Saw began principal photography on September 22nd, 2003, and was released in October of 2004. So that was probably intentional. The September 11th thing.
What the fuck? Huh. That's real weird.
Even
then.
Stranger.
Yeah.
Are they saying he's behind it?
What a jigsaw trap.
Yeah. Do 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 do.
Yeah. So Saw Spiral. Definitely recommend it. There are like the kills are kind of are gnarly, but nothing too bad. But again, there's a bit where there's like a guy's getting their back shredded by broken glass, and I was like, that's not that bad, because I had just previously watched the Dark Side of the Ring with Nick Gage, where he died for 7 minutes because he got his side cut open for broken glass. So I'm probably not the right
Holy
person.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Like, I watched that the other day, too. Oh, my God.
Yeah. So I'm probably not the right person to judge that kind of stuff. But, yeah. So
that
the
shit is wild.
Yeah. The Dark Side of the Ring episode with Nick Gage is tremendous, and I highly recommend watching it.
So,
and yeah,
it's real good. Lots of Moxley there. I cannot wait to see John Moxley and Nick Gage beat the shit out of each other.
Oh, yeah. That's going to be great. Yeah. Mox is so good in that episode.
So how was the theater experience, Kelly?
Not bad.
Was it busy?
Not really.
And when did you go?
How was the time to go? Before
Saturday
it starts getting fucking packed
like,
again.
Yeah, Saturday at like 7:45 was our show.
Huh.
Man, we're going to be wanting to lock down in about 7 months.
Yeah. Yeah.
We are going to be missing that. We're all going to be like, man, remember that time we sat on the couch and didn't do shit?
Yep.
We didn't have to be nowhere. There ain't no work.
I have been in a couple of they did like my kids' honors day things at school. I did Zoe's last week and Jax's today, and there was a point at Zoe's. We're sitting in the gym, you know, and everybody's kind of filing in. I leaned over to Nicole and I said, oh, God, remember a year ago we couldn't do this shit? That was awesome.
Lee, you know what I learned from that Nick Gage documentary?
What's that?
Stop, drop, and roll. Don't work for shit.
Oh, my God.
Is that real? For real?
So they showed a clip and it talks about this match Nick Gage is in where he got set on fire, you know, and... And it was coming, obviously, but like his shirt got caught on fire and it wouldn't go out. And people yelling at him, you know, stop, drop and roll, stop, drop and roll. And so it cuts like, you know, hard cam to Nick Gage like today in the interview. And he's like, the yelling. So I did it. That stop, drop and roll. And you know something? That shit don't work.
Poor guy.
So they had to like shoot him with a fire extinguisher. But he was just so sincere. Like, you know what? That shit don't work.
Well, that's disappointing to learn.
But they showed the video and he sure as shit was rolling around and still on fire.
Yep.
he definitely was.
Yep. I did enjoy it. Like,
was he on grease fire? Like, was it a grease fire?
No, it was Roncinol, like lighter fluid.
Yeah, well, maybe stop, drop, and roll wasn't designed for someone who lit themselves on fire with lighter fluid.
Good point. Smart.
I liked the bit in the behind-the-scenes footage when he was bleeding out, and he was like, so can I, like, go out there still? And the doctors are like, no!
It's like, take this shit up! I gotta go back!
Yeah.
Tape it up!
They're like, no, you're dying. He's like, no, I'm fine. And they're like, we called you a helicopter. He's like, I don't need a helicopter. And then,
he's like, get it on film. At least get it on film that I want to go back out there. These pussies aren't letting me.
Like, and then they cut to him now, man. And he's like, and then I died for 7 minutes on that helicopter.
Oh, my God.
And they showed the time where you almost killed David Arquette. That was cool.
I still remember... Because I ordered that show, like, and it was a Saturday night. I had come home from work, and it was running late, and plus it was a show from L.A., so I was like, I'm going to bed. I'll catch the rest of it in the morning. And I wake up, you know, I look at my phone and stuff, and just the wrestling group chats I'm in and and Twitter is just all, David Arquette tried to shoot on Nick Gage. David Arquette tried to shoot on Nick Gage. And I'm like, what the fuck did I miss? This one was this Dark Side of the Ring was interesting because this was like the first where it really felt like history that I have been around for and was aware of, you know? Because
like
this is all like I remember being on forums when Nick Gage was arrested after the robbing that bank and then him coming out of jail and then hearing about him dying and the David Arquette stuff. So it's like, oh, okay.
He robbed a bank?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
He had some real hard times.
Yeah, like, for real. He robbed a bank, but, like, and I think it was John Moxley who was like, you know, like, when Nick Gage comes to the ring, he wears a mask over his face, like a bandana over his face, like he's a gangster, like he's going to commit a crime. And then the one day he robs a fucking bank, he doesn't wear a mask at all. He just walks in there and robs the bank. He gets arrested almost immediately.
He's like, I'm vaccinated, MDK.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that Mahoney, the documentaries might be worth watching. It's fascinating.
No.
That one and the New Jack one.
We've determined what Mahoney's gateway to wrestling is going to be. We're going to show him matches and let him do commentary.
Yep.
Yeah, I have some suggestions for them.
Mahoney, you know what's sad?
What?
The Miz got hurt in that clip you saw.
Oh, really?
Well, real disappointing.
He tore his ACL during that stupid zombie match.
Oh, come on. God. That's a bad one. Oh, yeah. No.
Wasn't even doing anything.
No.
So what was Batista thinking booking that?
I will say, if you want some good Miz content, I caught up on Miz and Mrs. this past weekend. There's a lot of good Maurice Hoot content in that show.
Love her to death.
Yeah, yeah. Entertaining program. Miz and his dad went fishing. His dad kicked him into the lake.
Ohio what a trash. Now, if I what had Miz, if I had Miz's dad as a father-in-law, I would definitely curse around him because he's garbage.
Oh yeah. I like that Miz's mom and dad are divorced, and yet they both still live at Miz's house.
I did not realize that.
Yeah. One of the episodes was Maurice helping her mom and Miz's mom make dating profiles.
Oh, and Miz's mom is a real... She's a real ghoul.
Yeah.
If you want real good Miz content, you can go on to... Paramount Plus and watch old seasons of The Challenge. And that is something worth your time.
Miz's mom was getting massaged by a man and she kept telling it was making her juices flow.
Oh.
Ooh. Oh, Jesus Christ, Miz's mom.
Oh. Just like Cincinnati yeah, chili.
That's nice policy.
Too far, Miz's mom. Take us out of this, Mahoney. Talk about anything but Miz's mom's juices.
Lee. I don't know what I have to tell you about other than Mrs. Mom's juices. It's actually my list when I was making it this week. It was all about Mrs. Mom's juices.
It's profoundly upsetting.
Mahoney, was it this past week that I accidentally spoiled Suits for you?
It was. You jerk. Just terrible. So when I was just minding my own business when Kelly decided that he had to spoil Suits for me, which, you know, wicked rude. But that's okay. That's fine. Because by the time I get around to watching Suits, I'm sure I'll have forgotten.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And
Kelly was at least apologetic, not like some people who spoil shit.
And you're barely going to watch it, too.
Oh, yeah. But anyways, when Kelly wasn't spoiling Suits for me, Lee, have you been told about this new trend on the internet?
Oh, God damn.
Where...
No.
There's this song. I don't know what the song is called, but it's a big hit, Lee, and it's all about going to the gym. And when the woman in the song is not with Jim, J-I-M, she's in the gym, G-Y-M, getting ripped tonight. And Lee, it's the hottest thing on the internet. And I know how much you like to be up on trend. And so I have collected for you a series of videos helping you stay up to date on the hottest things. So here is this man. What do you think of this outfit, Lee?
I think he's got a whole vibe going right here. It's a real.
This is a really nice vibe. He's got some really great shorts, and he's got some kind of headband. I think there's a palm tree tattooed on his arm.
I think it might be a beret, and those are pleated sky blue shorts with a fabric belt tied in a bow.
Really big.
Big old bow.
Like cut off scrubs or something.
Yeah.
So, Lee, if this dude were to tell you that he's getting ripped tonight, you'd buy in, right?
Sure.
So how does the normal song go? It goes... I'm getting ripped tonight. R.I.P. that pussy. Hey, right?
Yeah, okay. Exactly. Exactly.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that old ditty. Yeah.
Hit play.
I'm getting ripped tonight. R.I.P. that... Raggy? Ro-oh!
What?
Swipe right.
Oh
left.
My God!
So you see, Lee, what he's done now is he's taken the "I'm Woo! Getting ripped tonight" dance,
yeah,
and he's added in an impression.
Mm. Yeah, so
this is the hot new trend. Was. This is the hot new trend. You take the dance, you take the song, but
and you don't do it.
It was really
you don't
interesting.
Do it all the way. You add in an impression
that he decided to add, you know, to take that song and add a Ronald Reagan impression.
It was a very good Ronald Reagan impression, though. Yeah. You got to admit.
So this happened because this guy did that.
Well, no, I mean, it didn't happen because he did that. He's riding the trend. And now he's you know, it evolves over time. So you can't just do the same thing over and over again. So now, instead of the old trend, now what you do is
you do... I don't mean to cut you off, but what this means is, you guys, and just kind of put this in context, this means that Mahoney's algorithm is so fucked up that he sees multiples of these. Like, they just come to him.
I have, Lee. Like this next one.
I'm hitting rip tonight. R.I.P. that Mike Wazowski. I'm watching you. Always watching you.
I like her.
Now, those are some shorts.
Yeah, right? That was a good one.
Was it?
Yeah.
That was a good Renee Zellweger.
You liked that one.
Good thighs.
Remember that scene in Jerry Maguire?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. He was like, show me the money. And she was like, I'm always watching. Like, oh, yeah.
Mike Wazowski, his partner.
Yeah.
Mike Wazowski and his good buddy, Cuba Gooding Jr.
Yep.
Exactly. All right. So that was a good Renee Zellweger. Lee, what
you
kind
had
of impression?
Me at hello.
What would you, if you had to pick an impression to do at the end of this dance, what would you be looking for? Like, what would you want?
Macho Man Randy Savage.
Okay, well, I don't have that, but do you like Family Guy?
Oh, God. Yeah, sure.
Okay, I knew it.
I'm getting ripped tonight. R.I.P. that. Ow, Peter.
Okay, that one worked for me. I don't know
why. See, I knew you liked that one.
That one worked for me. Don't know why.
All crazy. It.
Well, I think that one works best because she's going into a P word.
Right. Yeah. And it's very sexual.
So it flows better.
I was hoping she was going to be doing an impression of greased up deaf guy.
or the creepy old man across the street.
Yeah.
R.I.P. that paper boy.
What was...
Never going to catch me.
Kelly, when... Mahoney originally showed us the gif of the one chick doing this dance, the original dance. What did you what do you call her? There's a word.
I'm not going to say that.
No. There's a specific word.
There's
a specific word.
Go ahead,
that,
say it online.
There's a specific word that someone who might come into your place of business yells out in the middle of the store.
Yeah, but Kelly, it's safe. We're not recording this.
Yeah.
Nope.
Kelly, come on over here.
Not gonna do it.
Nope.
Not gonna do it.
Nope. No names.
That's not even a name. It's a word.
You're all enjoying it with the one impression, right? But what if there was more than one impression?
No. Oh,
that's a twist.
That's a twist, right?
I'm getting ripped tonight. R.I.P. that. But this is a real find. Just buy it. You don't have to rationalize everything. All right, I will buy it. It'll be good for the economy.
I legitimately have no idea what she was trying to do.
Was that Marge?
No, it was too fucking long. I know that.
That's Marge and Lisa.
Marge, yeah.
Oh, sure.
Not
okay.
As good as the Peter Griffin one.
Oh, my God.
Those are pretty good, right, Lee?
It's not funny. It's not interesting.
Is it not funny and interesting?
No. It's all right. Really not. This is very upsetting.
Okay. Well, I have good news. I found some funny and interesting talks.
Just the...
Tik Tok, motherfucker!
No, those aren't word talks, you fuck!
those were appetizers. Those were just to get your
pregame
watering. I mean, come on, Lee. Oh.
Well, this is off to a good start.
Yeah, Lee, we've had much worse starts.
We've had definitely worse starts.
What do you think this video is going to be about?
I hope it's about hoots.
I couldn't tell you. It could be about fucking anything. I'm going to say fucking, I don't know, scorpion.
Kelly, you got a guess? What do you think?
Hoots. I hope it's about hoots.
Okay. Jose, you got any thoughts?
Something about pumpkin spice?
All right, let's see.
I don't know.
So far, Kelly's right.
Oh, yeah. So we have
1984 Wonder Woman.
Okay.
Separator. A pink 2x2. Bimbo Batman. And She-Hulk.
I have that Batman minifigure.
Bimbo Batman.
Bimbo Batman.
And also Hoots. So yeah, you were
no,
right,
that was
Kelly.
A solid talk.
Yeah. When Mahoney asked Lee to guess what this video was going to be about, I thought in my head, what if he guesses it? What if he guesses she's drinking from a red Solo cup and then pulls 5 different Lego items out of it and names them individually?
I don't understand it at all.
Really high.
It's great.
She's real high, I'll tell you that.
Yeah. There's something going on over there. Her whole account is about Legos.
Bricks and bimbos.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, she seemed very knowledgeable about Legos because I don't know what that orange thing's called, but she's like, it's a brick separator. Here's a pink 2x2. I wouldn't know to call it that. I'd say the small one.
What would you call them?
I'd say the small one. Give me that small one.
But there's much smaller than that.
Yeah, there are ones much smaller.
Give me one of those. Look at the picture. Give me one of those.
I went back to her account and watched a handful of videos, and she's very knowledgeable about Legos. Give me the she's a big Lego fan.
Give me a small pink square one.
You know what, Mahoney? This is one of the best talks you've ever given us.
Thank you, Kelly. That means a lot to me. Kelly, do you like Wendy's chili?
Not really, no.
Okay. Lee, you like Wendy's chili?
It'll do.
Yeah, it'll do, right? What if it was like the only thing you were in the mood for?
I mean, I'm not going to say I haven't been there before.
Yeah, okay. Perfect.
Oh, I got to press play.
I forgot to order chili at Wendy's. My stomach is cramping so bad now. Oh my God, it's my turn. Oh my God. My car needs gas, so I can't go to the Wendy's further away, so I'm going home. And I'm not even going to have my chili that I want.
That's a rough night.
So wait, did she just order something else, or did she like get to the drive-thru, not order anything, and keep going?
I'm assuming
she probably got like some spicy nuggets and then just forgot that she also wanted chili.
Yeah.
So why didn't she
get spicy nuggets? That's enough. You're good.
She couldn't turn around. She didn't have any gas in her car.
Well, no. She didn't have enough
gas. She didn't have any
gas
in the car here.
Yeah,
she could have gone to the same one again.
No. She didn't want to be embarrassed that she had to go back and order chili.
Oh, that
cool.
And
so I'm going to post that on the internet then.
Also,
not embarrassing at all.
Having worked the drive-thru, I promise you, they would not have remembered.
Right.
No, yeah, God, no.
They would have been like, oh, this is that bitch we knew was going to order chili, and she didn't.
And she said she wanted to get the chili because she's got cramps. Like, is this a PMS thing? Is this a period thing? She needs chili to soothe her cramps?
Maybe
she needs to get some stuff moving. I feel like that would do the job.
Now, I will say, to her credit, Lee says that the drive-thru people would not have remembered her. She is one of the most famous TikTokers, so they might actually know who she is when she goes to Wendy's.
I mean, the Wendy's drive-thru might know who the fuck she is, but we sure don't.
No.
All right, you guys, like,
I can also guarantee that in working in retail, I've rung up people I know and did not recognize it. So,
well, then how do you know you did it?
Because they told me, like, hey, Kelly, what's going on? And I'm like, who are you? And then they told me who they are.
But then you don't exactly
that feel
know
like
them.
Per person you know.
Yeah,
you don't
really
know
who
they
them.
Are. Yeah.
You just glaze out. You just do the job. Like, fuck.
Yeah.
Next.
Yeah.
That's
true.
Next.
They're not people, they're obstacles.
Yep. All right. You like life hacks?
No.
You like, no. What are you talking about? No, of course you do. You like cleaning videos? Everybody likes to learn how to clean better, right?
I like that when you share
Mahoney,
the day, like,
Mahoney, movie. Life hack. Kelly loves life hacks. You don't have to ask him if he likes life hacks.
Okay, perfect. Kelly, buckle your seatbelt. Look at this ketchup. Big mound of ketchup on the counter. Look at this. You just soak it.
Yeah.
Soak the shit out of it with this spray,
okay.
Right?
All right.
Take one single paper towel.
Yep.
Look at that.
Just spread it everywhere.
Look at that. Look how well that works.
Yep.
Nailing it. Billy Mays here for one single piece of paper towel and a bunch of cleaning spray.
You know, I really think if she hadn't sprayed it at all, it would have been much easier to clean up.
Is that it?
What do you mean, Lee?
A million years.
No, some it's chick someone who can't work. It's part one.
Okay, how many TikToks, you know, they'll have like a million some odd views.
Yeah.
How much of that is like when things on CBS get millions of viewers because old people leave their TVs on, but in turn, like, this is for millennials who just leave their phones on and the videos like cycle through.
It doesn't, I would say a lot. Doesn't move. I wish I could just put it in front of me and let it cycle, but it won't. It'll just stay on the one video.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. Cause like whenever whenever I click on one of your links, it'll immediately start playing some other bullshit I don't care about afterwards.
Well, not in the app.
And then it's do you want the app? And I'm like, fucking no.
Yeah, I'm like, get that shit out of here. I haven't downloaded you yet because I don't want your ass on my phone.
Get out of here, China.
Yeah.
The bunch of you. China doesn't care what you're doing.
Oh, get this fucking shit out of here.
Lee, do you like
No one
share?
Wants to see the best share tweets.
This motherfucker. This is a wedgie wearing a man suit.
Go one. Drown and piss, Hank Green.
Want to see the best share tweets? I'm sure I put on 500 pounds in the last 2 days. Trump has mammoth ass and visible panty line. Nah. This tweet unavailable. I don't know what it was, but it says, then keep your eyes open, bitch. I need to shoot my phone.
I'm here for
That's
you, Mahoney.
What shares up for.
I'm here
Drown
for
and piss,
doing.
Hank Green. Drown and piss.
Kelly, I think you're going to really like this next one then.
If a swirly had a face, it would be Hank Green.
Kelly will like this,
this
one.
This one is about Hank Green and a controversial statement he made. And this teenager is trying to get him canceled.
I hate it already because this asshole is holding the microphone up to his mouth, which is completely unnecessary.
Oh, no. That's a thing that they do. That's a thing that they do on TikTok. People are, I don't know.
Because they don't know how their technology works. And they saw one other person do it on TikTok, so now they do it.
Well, I mean, to be fair, he sounds great, so let's listen.
If you weren't already made aware, Hank Green, popular TikTok personality, made a very controversial statement yesterday on his TikTok account, which is causing much debate in the scientific community. I will play the clip for you now. However, be wary. It is very offensive. You have been warned.
Christ.
Hey, it's me, Hank Green. Did you know that space isn't real, you fucking idiots?
Okay, that one's good.
Yeah, I like that one.
That's the best one of the night.
I really do believe he would say that space isn't real.
Hey! He sounded very Italian Hank Green in that in that clip.
Oh, God. Okay. I feel like we've seen 11 talks. That has to be the last one,
well,
right?
No, there's still one left. There's still one more.
Oh, my God.
There's still one more.
No! Oh, I hate this one already.
Remember how good the first one started? This is the polar opposite of that.
I think you guys might come around on this one.
I think you'll enjoy it.
Doubt it.
You like Marmite, Lee?
No! What the fuck is Marmite?
It's kind of like Vegemite. It's a weird Australian breakfast thing.
Clears it up.
Marmite is apparently the like waste produced when you make beer. And then they bottle it up and you spread it on toast.
Fuck!
And if you eat too much of it, it actually poisons you.
Cool.
I finally got it. It's Marmite! They say I'm either gonna love it or I'm gonna hate it. Did I ever try this before? Nah.
Look at
it. I put a good amount on and let's go! I'm gonna do Marmite side down so all the flavors can go all over my taste buds.
Oh, Jesus.
That's the fourth time I've watched that today, and it cracks me up every time.
It's so good.
After the second time I watched it, Mary had to come in here and check on me.
She's so upset. The fucking look in her eyes. And the filter doesn't stop. It's amazing.
Oh, it's so good. I love the fuck.
Oh boy.
All right.
Unbelievable. I'd like to believe that's what they actually look and sound like.
Yeah, it's not a filter.
I was telling Mahoney.
Matt is a Vegemite.
If their channel is nothing but them doing food reviews, but with that filter, I want to subscribe.
I think I need to go and look them up.
Oh, that's something else. That was something else. That got me.
That was a good one.
Whew, that one was exhausting. That was rough.
Lee, how about some ice cream to make you feel better there, champ?
I would love some ice cream to make you feel better. I might go get an ice cream cone in just a minute, matter of fact. Yeah. What we got for a classic this week, Nice?
All right. Well, based on our ice cream theme this week, I know we've played the Stone Cold Creamery commercials a few times as PopCast classics, but...
You know why, Nice? Because they're fucking great.
They're fucking great, but... I one-upped it because I found the origin of Stone Cold Creamery from episode 305, July 29th, 2015. I mistakenly say Stone Cold Creamery instead of Cold Stone Creamery. And if you notice, this is episode 304. A scant 12 episodes later, we would do our entire Stone Cold episode. So this is the genesis of that.
Enjoy this look at PopCast history. Be back in a minute. Love you. Bye.
Enjoy the refreshing taste of an ice-cold PopCast classic.
And during the break, I was productive. I went and peed. I ate a banana. I ate two Oreos. I had a talk with my dad. And now I'm here.
Nice.
Got a lot done.
You ate the banana and then the two Oreos, or did you alternate?
I ate the banana while I was talking to my dad, and then as I was coming back, I realized, I can grab two Oreos on my way. And they're the birthday cake Oreos, so they're slightly more sweet than the normal, just traditional cream Oreos. They're pretty good.
Yeah, I like cake. Let me just put that out there.
Cake's great.
But I've never been a fan of birthday cake flavor. Like birthday cake Oreos or like the birthday cake ice cream that they have at Stone Cold, like, or Cold Stone.
Ah, you want some of this? We got your toppings over here. You can fill this goddamn cup up.
We all fucking fell over each other trying to do a Stone Cold impersonation.
You got your sprinkles? What? Hot fudge? What?
What?
Crush up Oreos? What?
What?
Got your gummy worms? And when it's all over, we're going to charge this some bitch by weight.
Oh, hell yeah.
I love you guys. Shit. What were we even talking about?
I don't even remember anymore.
Oh, yeah. It's like an Oreos.
Cake, birthday right, cake.
Yeah.
Mahoney's crying already.
And like, if you say birthday cake flavor, it's like, it's not taking into consideration people that, like, want chocolate cake for their birthday.
Yeah, that's true.
It's birthday segregation. That's what it is.
Going back to the Stone Cold impressions, did you guys listen to the episode of Will Sasso's podcast where he was pretending to be Stone Cold the entire show and was just reading off lists?
No, but...
Gavin was telling everyone that he could to listen to this show.
Gavin does a good Stone Cold.
It was pretty amazing because it's just... him reading just random lists of things like trees and colors and cheeses in alphabetical order.
Top 10 cheeses. What?
Oh, shit, Tommy, I got a list of colors right here. We got fuchsia, we got plum, we got crimson. And it's just 10 minutes of that, and it's so much funnier than it should be.
Well, wasn't the story that Sasso was on Roddy Piper's podcast doing the Stone Cold impersonation, and they were kind of talking about Stone Cold, and Stone Cold did not appreciate it. And that's kind of why Piper's persona non grata with WWE now. He's joined Hogan and Benoit and CM Punk in that illustrious Hall of Fame.
Really?
Yeah. Piper has gotten insane in his old age, and
he's batshit crazy.
He will straight start shit with you.
Yeah, he's out of his fucking mind.
He's all out of bubblegum. Is the problem. He ran out of bubblegum about 1994.
Well, goddamn, kid, you must have ran out of that there bubblegum.
Why don't you go paint half your body black and see what you can do about it?
They got that paint gimmick and put it on half of you.
Oh, my God.
Hey, Naz, why don't we hear about them gimmicks called news?
Let's do the news.
We'll do it live. Give them that hot news gimmick.
Do it live.
Fuck it.
We'll write it, and we'll do it live. Fuck it.
Oh, hell yeah. This is the Pop Top Six-Pack of News for July 28th, 2015. I thought about doing it in the Stone Cold voice, but I didn't know if I'd be able to hold it the entire time. So maybe
get
another
some
time.
More fucking news in this bitch.
Do a show where you're Stone Cold, I'm Dusty.
No, fuck it. We do a show where we're all Stone Cold.
Oh my God.
Nothing quenches your thirst quite like a podcast classic.
See, and if you know your history, you know that on episode 316, we did a show where we were all Stone Cold, except for Jose, who was a weird hybrid of Macho Man and Hulk Hogan.
You know, I think when 632 rolls around, we're going to have to roll that back and try to do it again.
632. Oh, hell yeah. Stone Cold 632 says we talk like Stone Cold again. You take 316, add another 316, you get 632. That means double the Stone Cold. Oh, hell yeah. We got Mahoney here to do the voice this time.
Yeah, I don't think I was there last time, no. But I feel
Sean
like
Hart
I
silly salt bitch.
I feel like I've since done a Stone Cold voice, and you all made fun of me for it.
And you're going to have to do it the whole show.
We'll see.
632. Stone Cold, put it on the books.
What are we on now? 538?
It's gonna be a while. No, it is 559.
Oh, okay.
I didn't even pay attention.
Are you sure Lee didn't say 538 at the beginning?
I am not sure. I was not paying attention.
I bet he did.
Wait, what is it?
559? It doesn't matter.
That's the rock. I know.
Oh, no. I said 558. God damn it.
Oh, God damn it.
You remember the news?
Yeah, I remember that. It was a fun time.
That was before we were a wrestling podcast.
And TikTok curators.
Fucking ridiculous. All right, so...
Where we were getting ripped all night.
Hey!
Ripping in a tearing.
R.I.P. that. Pass me a Steve Weiser, you dumb son bitch.
Does the original song sound as monotone as all those people did when they were making that video?
No.
No. It's a very good song, Kelly. You should listen to it.
I'm getting ripped tonight.
I believe the song is called Dick.
Oh, yeah, of course.
You know, the Grammy Award winning.
Yeah.
Oh.
I believe it's Dick by Starboy.
Oh, thank God.
But not all of those letters are letters. I think some of them are numbers. So,
you mean
Google
those are written by the Beatles?
What an asshole.
It might have been. Yeah. Ringo might have done this.
Ringo.
Oh man, that would have been that would be great.
I guess if any of the Beatles did write it, it would have been Ringo.
I'm getting
Ringo got
tonight.
A TikTok account.
Probably.
I'm getting ripped tonight.
Okay,
R.I.P.
so it's
that
Star
pussy.
Boy B O I. Starboy B O I 3. And the song is called Dick.
All right.
Cool. Pretty good. You're gonna enjoy it.
All right. Very cool.
At this point now, if someone has a number in their musical name, I assume they have attempted to or have diddled a kid.
Wow.
What the fuck, Ellie?
Makes sense.
What the fuck was that noise?
Sounds like Dick.
Oh, is that the song?
It sounds like we're getting demonetized.
They won't pick it up.
All right.
Well, yeah, but Mahoney, do a dance real quick, and then it's allowed.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine, because it's just a TikTok video, so.
Well, I don't know if this will get us demonetized.
We're a food podcast again this week.
Yeah, I don't know if this will get us demonetized, but we'll give it a shot anyhow.
As Spooky Skeletons has shown.
Oh, yeah, this is definitely going to get us demonetized.
Yeah, the Beatles definitely wrote this one.
Look
all right,
him.
So this week, we are going to be counting down, or not counting, ranking
our favorite choppas.
Ice cream truck treats, which is a really hard thing to say. Ice cream truck treats.
Ice cream truck treats.
Yeah, good times. So, you know, we're all going to collab on a list, and then I just put like 25 things on there, and I went to look at it, I'm like, I fucking got all the good ones. I was like, oh shit, there's nothing left. I tried 3 times today, and I'd be doing something like, oh, shit, I got... Oh, no, that's on there already. So, like I said in our group chat today, if you ever find an ice cream truck with more than 30 items, they're fucking lying to you. There aren't more than 30.
At one point, like, I was thinking about, there are some ice cream trucks that, like, sell bags of chips as well. I was like, chili cheese Fritos, maybe? I don't know.
Just there's a list item that just goes, I don't know, a fucking bag of chips?
What's your favorite ice cream truck? Cheetos.
Wood chips.
How far would Cheetos make it before we realized we hadn't cut it yet?
Pretty far.
Cheetos makes it to like number 15 on the list. We're like, how the fuck?
If Cheetos was on this list, I'd make a strong argument for why it should be number 1.
Mahoney loves Cheetos. He will stand in the
Cheetos
kitchen and
great.
Eat an entire bag of Cheetos.
Hell yeah.
But we did put together a list. We got 30 of some of the most common ice cream truck items. Whether or not your favorite's on here, that remains to be seen. But I think we covered a lot of variety, which there is not a lot of. Because like I said to Mahoney, ice cream truck treats are a lot like Taco Bell, where they just take the same 5 ingredients and put them in different shapes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So
also, if your favorite's not on here, shut up about it, because there's nothing we can do about it.
So what what do we got here? That first one, I gotta find that one because it's a very specific name.
Yeah.
Oh, that
like
one
it's
was put
classic.
On the list as vanilla bar. So in the top left hand corner, we got a Hershey's premium ice cream bar. Made by Good Humor. It's the basic vanilla ice cream chocolate outer layer with a stick in it. Then we got the King Cone, which is vanilla ice cream, chocolate fudge, peanuts on it. We got your chocolatey Claire, which is usually like the chocolate crunchy bits on the outside, some vanilla ice cream, some chocolate ice cream. Then you got the strawberry shortcake, which is very similar to that, but in strawberry flavors. We got your creamsicle / dreamsicle, I guess, whatever company's making it or regionally, which is orange outside, creamy inside. Just like Donald Trump.
Oh, that's a girl you should date.
Next up, there's the firecracker, but it's more commonly known as a rocket pop or a bomb pop, but I just couldn't find a better picture than this firecracker from the actual Supersicle Popsicle company. So, you know, it's red, white, and blue. What is it? Cherry, white lemon, and blue raspberry flavors. Super think patriotic.
So. Yeah, because it's a popsicle, white and blue. Right?
Yeah, it's a popsicle.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then this next one is very similar to that, but it's chocolate and banana fudge firecracker, which I don't know if I've ever seen that before, but I always remember some sort of chocolate banana concoction that no one wants. You know, usually a frozen banana dipped in chocolate, but again, I couldn't find evidence that that ever existed on an ice cream truck. Not a whole lot of digital footprint from the ice cream truck community.
Yeah, no, they like to stay off the grid.
As much as possible.
We got Fudgesicle, which, you know, self-explanatory, just a big old bar of cold chocolate. Next row down, we got your ice cream sandwich with the vanilla inside, the chocolate. What would you even call that? Chocolate wafer, chocolate cookie? It's not really
a cookie. I would say wafer. Cookie.
Yeah, it's more like squishy, bready almost, but
yeah,
classic.
It's more cakey than anything.
Yes,
really.
I would say I would agree with that, like cakey.
If you don't know what an ice cream sandwich is, just turn off your
turn off the podcast, go eat an ice cream sandwich.
Then we've got that, but Neapolitan ice cream on the inside, so chocolate, vanilla, strawberry. Real bougie. I don't know if I've ever seen one of those. Fancy.
Real bougie ice cream.
Next up, an Oreo cookie sandwich. You know what we're talking about. Made by Klondike, I didn't realize. At least at one point. Then next to that, various names. Chipwich, ice cream cookie sandwich, whatever. This is called the premium cookie sandwich. Two chocolate chip cookies, vanilla ice cream, and then the vanilla ice cream is dipped in chocolate chips. Up next to that, the screwball, which is cherry slushed ice with a bubble gum ball at the bottom of it. A snow cone made by Popsicle.
Somebody's choking on that.
This one's rainbow flavored. Next up, the bubblegum swirl, which is pink and blue. It's a pink and blue Popsicle bar. Then we got the original push-up next to that, but we're grouping them all together. Push-up, pop-up, whatever. I remember the Flintstones ones from back in the day. But you know, you know, the orange one is like the most famous, but they had all kinds of different flavors of those. You know what you're getting. Up next, the Choco Taco fried ice cream, also made by Klondike at one point. It's basically a waffle taco with vanilla ice cream, caramel on the inside, covered in nuts and chocolate. You want to get real fancy, get yourself a Snickers ice cream bar. Holy
shit.
Also
delicious.
Those are great. You better bring $5 to the ice cream truck if you want to buy one of those.
Those are so good.
We got your basic drumstick, which, you know, whether vanilla, chocolate, caramel in the center, we all know what a drumstick is at this point.
Yeah. I just housed a drumstick a moment ago.
Wonderful. Basic-ass Klondike bar, basically that premium ice cream bar from the beginning, but no stick in it. You got to eat it with your fucking hands like a savage.
Klondike bars are fine. Klondike bars with different flavored ice cream, like...
Or, like, you know, toppings. They got, like, the different, like, crunchies in them and stuff.
Yeah, right. those are far superior.
We got a vanilla sundae with fudge, and I think some of those have nuts in them. Just basically a sundae cup. Usually they come with a little wooden spoon. You know, you can get 100 of those for $1 probably. That was probably the biggest moneymaker at the fucking ice cream truck. You got your Nestle's Crunch Dibs, which are just little chocolate bonbons covered in Nestle Crunch chocolate. Yes, please.
I've never gotten those off an ice cream truck, but I've gotten those at the movie theater.
Yeah, movie theater for real.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
One that you're probably not going to find on an ice cream truck unless it's just the rich neighborhood at Christmas time, but it's Dippin' Dots. But we were really struggling for 30 on this list, so we put the space cream on space ice cream on there. The ice cream of the future was their tagline. We got your – this is Luigi's Real Italian Ice, but just Italian ice as a concept is on our list. I think a lot of the times you would find Italian ice trucks on their own just running around, not necessarily finding Italian ice in the ice cream truck. All right, last row. We got the WWF Superstars ice cream bars, which were...
This thing looks awful.
Cookie, vanilla ice cream, and then chocolate. And they had pictures of your favorite wrestlers at the time. This one in particular was Lex Luger, and I bet you
if you're a kid and you went up to the ice cream truck and you ordered a WWF Superstars bar, they gave you a Lex Luger, you were super disappointed. We got
the story checks out.
Mickey True Original Mickey Premium Bar. This is the kind of Mickey bar that you would find in like the Disney parks, and only recently they've started selling them at stores, but fuck it, we threw it on here anyhow. It's our list. And then basically the rest of the list is the character faces with the gumball eyes. We got Spider-Man, we got Bubbles from the Powerpuff Girls, we got your Ninja Turtle, and we got your Sonic the Hedgehog. And that is a pretty, I would say, a pretty dope ice cream truck menu if we were going to put together a Panels on Pages ice cream truck.
Yeah, let's fucking do it.
Let's do it. Mm-hmm. So we picked our order beforehand, so we're going to start at number 30. The order is going to go myself, Kelly, Lee, Mahoney, and Jose. And just like we did with the Marvel movies, we're going to pick an ice cream and get down till we get to the number one best ice cream on the board. So, number 30, the Iron Man 3 spot.
God damn.
Which is...
honorable Iron Man 3.
Yeah. Controversial sometimes, I would say. All right. Well, we talked about it a little bit, that you could probably make the most money off of these on the ice cream truck, but man, it's so fucking basic, and that wooden spoon just didn't taste good. So number 30, I'm going to put Sunday cup.
Oof. And you just know the Sunday cup.
You know that like kids are getting fucking splinters on their tongues. Like,
no, no. Yeah, so like, see, I think I have a different experience with these because up here, they're called Hoodsy Cups because they're from Hood. We all know how good Hood eggnog is. Like,
they do ice cream?
These are Hood ice cream. Yes, Hood ice cream is the best ice cream you'll ever have. And it's Hoodsy Cups, little tiny Hood Sunday Cups. They're totally different than these ones that have the like chocolate sauce in them. It's just vanilla and chocolate ice cream. It's still got the little wooden spoon. And they're great. And they're great. But I can at least take comfort in these kind of knockoff like vanilla ice cream with the chocolate sauce mixed in with them. Like, those are not very great. Yeah, like, those are a big disappointment.
You take the chocolate out and these are basically what my parents feed their dog for dessert. You don't want to use your we all do have saves again like we did with the Marvel
oh,
movies.
No.
You're not going to use your save on Sunday Cup at 30.
If you were getting rid of the Hood brand, he may have jumped in.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you were trying to tell me Hoodsy Cups was number 30, I would lose my mind, but I'm not saving these.
No. All right. I'm making my pick. I'm knocking this one off its high horse immediately. Klondike bar, get the fuck out of here.
Oh, man.
Ooh,
wow. Klondike bar at number 29.
Yeah, fuck a Klondike bar.
What would you do to fuck a Klondike bar?
It's inconvenient.
Apparently.
They're pretty lame. What have you done?
Why isn't it? I broke it.
I don't know. I'll fix it.
Like, you know, fucking Klondike bar, it's going to explode in your hands.
And it thinks so goddamn highly of itself.
Yeah. That you got your fancy fucking foil wrapper.
Yeah. What would you do for a Klondike bar? Fucking nothing. Whatever. I'd pay a buck for it.
The only thing Klondike bars have going for them is they're big.
Yeah.
It's a lot.
All the other polar bears are doing coke, and you're over here with Klondike.
Yeah. No. Get out of here.
Yeah. No. Fuck that thing. All right. I'm going to kick right off the top of a fucking bridge. A Neapolitan ice cream sandwich.
Wild.
I thought you put that on the list.
I may have.
Just to kick it the fuck off.
I put it there to kill it.
Yeah. I had to get it out of there. For the same reason being that, like, you know, if you've ever had a carton of Neapolitan ice cream, it's like, yeah, the chocolate goes first. Then you have like a canyon of vanilla. And then next thing you know, you just have a like a third of a quart of fucking strawberry ice cream in your freezer. Like, nobody wants it. Like, it's just, you know, it's
Lee Rodriguez.
Well, I literally thought you were saving the best for last, and that's why you were eating the strawberry last. Like, I did not understand at all.
Yeah.
You're telling me you're not going to finish an ice cream sandwich?
Oh, I would finish an ice cream sandwich, but I'm never getting that one. Like, fuck that thing.
Like, wild. Like, you said it yourself. It's too fucking bougie. That's a bougie-ass ice cream sandwich. There's too much going on.
Well, dress me up fancy, because I'm all about it. I'm not going to save it. But no. If I had to choose between a regular ice cream sandwich and a Neapolitan ice cream sandwich, hell yeah, I want the Neapolitan ice cream sandwich. Same.
Definitely.
Why would I want regular if I can have Neapolitan?
Yeah, but you got so much else on that board.
I don't know. The regular one is classic. Like,
I like the regular, but I like the Neapolitan one,
too. You want the regular one? Great. It's a third. It's a third of the... And then you got two other kinds mixed in. You get three for the price of one.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jose.
Bonkers.
Then you'd be on my side.
Yeah.
All right, well...
This early, because I'm not ordering that over any of this other shit.
No fucking way. No fucking way.
No. Not over any
There's
of this other shit.
There's a fucking Ninja Turtle
you're
with
gonna,
a gum nose.
Italian ice over ice. The Neapolitan ice cream sandwich.
Yes.
You know, they got a good flavor, Mahoney. I just might.
Yeah, I probably would. I like
I would
Italian
take the
ice.
Italian ice, but you know what I wouldn't take? Motherfucking snow cones. Get it out of here.
It's not your pick.
Why not?
Because it's my pick.
Oh, well, Mahoney picked snow cone.
Yeah. I mean, that sounded like Mahoney that said it.
Hey,
I
like
mean, listen, I'm not opposed. Snow cones suck. So
yeah, it says
go ahead,
snow
drop
cone.
Snow cone at 26. That's fine. Because number 27 is the WWF nonsense. That thing looks like shit.
I can't defend it. I never had it.
Look at it. It looks absolutely terrible.
It was before my time.
Yeah, but it's Lex Luthor.
What's going on here, guys?
I'm trying to fix my mistake. I'm fixing it. Don't worry about it.
Well, we both can't fix it.
It's too late. I already fixed it.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Looking at the pictures of it now.
Yeah. Oh my god.
I look at the pictures of this ice cream bar, these WWE ones, and they really do look terrible.
And then they came out with them again way after CM Punk was begging for him to come back, and they just did ice cream sandwiches.
Lame. Yeah. They probably did Neapolitan.
Luther Vandross. Can we take our ranking ice cream truck treats seriously, please, guys?
Come on, guys.
I thought we were ranking ice cream truck drivers.
Now
I'm looking at a picture of a Hillbilly Jim ice cream bar. That's a real fucking thing that exists, apparently. Ridiculous.
Now
I wouldn't even know what you told me. That's a cookie. Like, it just looks like it's just tan. It's not a good color. I don't want.
Yeah. Okay. So
tan.
One side of it is like the cookie, the tan part. The back of it is like the regular ice cream sandwich cookie wafer business we discussed before. But the cookie side, the tan cookie side, has like a weird fucking weird printed image of a wrestler on it. It's very bizarre.
I don't like it at all. It looks absolutely worst part. Like, I already was predisposed to not enjoy it, but it's just it couldn't have lived up to its awful hype any better.
It's almost like we put it on the list knowing Mahoney would pick it first.
Yeah, it saved something else that I really wanted to get rid of.
I do want, like, the snow cone that you would get from the ice cream truck is bullshit, but man, I love a legit ass snow cone. But the one you would get from the ice cream truck was always hard as a rock.
Oh yeah,
just bullshit.
Yeah.
If you're telling me there's snow cone and Italian ice, I'm ordering the Italian ice.
Like the
snow
cone, yeah.
The ice cream truck snow cone, you would have to let melt for 5 minutes or something before it was edible.
Be like, motherfucker, I got ice in my freezer. I don't need you to roll up on my block to tell me about ice. I got ice. I got flavor. I got red. I got blue.
All right. Fuck all that. I'm up next. I think I'm going to keep with the theme of my last pick, which was the Sunday Cup. And this one is basically a Sunday Cup in a cone. So number 25, I'm going King Cone. Something that just does not look appealing to me, even though it's probably delicious. Like, this is all delicious. I would eat all of this. But I would never pick a King Cone over all this other stuff.
Really?
No.
They're very good.
I'm sure they are. I mean,
yeah, you know what? Yeah, they're fine. But like, even if it's just down to, you know, King Cone or
drumstick. It's a drumstick all the
exactly.
way.
Exactly.
So yeah, every time. Oh, forgot sure. King Kong. Yeah. No. Fuck off, King Kong.
All right, then for my next pick at 24, I am dumping the screwball.
All right, I got to use my save.
Really?
Oh,
really?
Screwball. I'm a fan of screwball. Screwball. It's probably not going to last very much longer on this list, but I at least gotta put it out there because screwball was my go-to ice cream truck choice for the longest time.
Okay.
Screwball's a solid. It's a solid pick
because
you get gum and fucking tasty.
I honestly don't know if I've ever seen that offered up here.
And see, that's the thing too.
I don't think so either.
Where else are you gonna find something like that? I don't know if you could buy screwballs anywhere but the ice cream truck. And to be perfectly honest, it's crap. It's trash. It's not that good. But it's a gimmick, and the gimmick got me as a little fat child. Love me a screwball. So my save is off the board.
All right. So let me take a look back at this list.
Nope. Saving it.
All right. I'm thinking just because it's a very basic thing that I do enjoy, but I think I might rather have everything else on the list. I might go fudgesicle.
All right.
Hold on.
Again, like, I could house over the span of a week a box of fudgesicles in my freezer, but if an ice cream truck pulls up out in front of my house and I can choose any of these motherfuckers, I'm not picking a fudgesicle ever.
Yeah. I mean, I just... Like, a plain-ass popsicle is on this list. If I gotta choose between a popsicle or a fudgicle, fudgicle every single time. So I don't disagree that there's plenty of things on this list that I would choose above a fudgicle. But I just feel like it's a bit too early. I'm not gonna save it. I just feel like it's a bit too early.
Fudgicle the Iron Man 3?
It might be. I mean,
all right,
plain ass popsicle.
Oh man, now that I think of it, there was an Iron Man bar with the bubblegum eyes. I should have put it on this list and picked it as 30.
Yeah.
Booted him first.
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna go fucking get out of here, Rocket Pop. You basic ass Rocket Pop.
Oh man.
Because again, like I said, you got all this stuff, you're gonna have this boring ass weird, like, because it says cherry, lemon, and none of those flavors actually taste like those flavors. It just tastes like a weird hodgepodge amalgamated fucking popsicle.
And if you didn't eat the shit quick, that blue's all over your hand.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I blew yourself.
You blew yourself.
Look like a jerked off a Smurf.
Yeah, the fact that it has three different flavors. Come on, get over yourself. It's one flavor.
Yeah, fuck off. It's bomb pop flavor, and that's not great.
Yeah, it's popsicle flavored.
Yeah. Right. What flavor is that one? Oh, it's cold.
Hopefully, freezes.
All right, I'm sticking with the theme here, and I'm saying that the next worst thing on this list is this bubblegum swirl. Like, if you're a popsicle, get the fuck out.
Yeah, bubblegum swirl was the last one that we added to the list, and it was just like, I kept seeing it come up. I've never seen it actually in person. I was like, all right, well, this looks different enough. Let's throw it on the list. So it's lucky it got to number 22.
I can't imagine what it must taste like. Like, I don't want a lump of cold bubblegum flavored.
I bet you it tastes like a fucking urinal cake.
Oh my god. Way to sell it. Fucking hell.
Buying stock tomorrow. All right. This is also kind of like a personal thing. Because me and Bananas, we got a hit or miss relationship. And banana ice cream can get the fuck out of here. So, banana fudge
Cracker.
Yeah, I would almost say that that one should have gone
Firecracker.
Before the Rocket Pock, like, because they're the same shape, but yeah, that can go.
Yeah, get the fuck out of here. I'm done with you.
Yep. No complaints about that.
Imagine being the kid at the ice cream truck that's like, yes, I'll have the chocolate banana firecracker, and that kid just gets bullied relentlessly. Jose, did you just...
What?
Mahoney's name changed from Mahoney to Jose back to Mahoney somehow.
Not me.
Yeah, I wouldn't change it because he took a spot twice. So, yeah, I'll just change the order.
Oh, okay.
It's fine. No, he didn't take my spot twice.
No, he went.
Because Mahoney picked the bubble gum.
He picked bubble gum.
I did the bubble gum. That's right. I'm sorry. I take it back.
Wow.
Hey, I'm going to take a spot next time, though. If I'm going to get blamed for it, I'm going to do
Listen, I have the prime spot. I don't know if you've all put this together, but I determined the winner, so I'm not giving up this spot.
Well, no, Jose determines the winner. Oh, yeah, you do.
Yeah,
you
out
do.
Of one choice. Yeah, you do. Congratulations.
You do. Yeah, but what if I denounce that one? We just don't have a winner?
Well, that's what happened last time when you save your save for the very end.
Ooh, I fucking decide this.
Maybe.
Fuck, he's drunk with power.
Also drunk.
All right, I'm going to go with this one because it's super basic. And if you're going to get this, why not get it shaped like Mickey Mouse? So I'm going to go with number 20, Vanilla Bar.
Yep.
Yeah.
But, however,
yeah.
Vanilla Bar and Klondike Bar, similar. Just one has a stick shoved up its ass.
Yeah, and one isn't so far up its own ass.
I would almost prefer the Vanilla Bar because I don't have to hold it in my hot, sweaty little pink hands.
Yeah, you don't have to hold it. For sure. The Klondike Bar is too thick, so the weak-ass casing that it's in can't contain it. It's bullshit.
Yeah. But, again... Vanilla covered in chocolate.
You can't
Why get
wrong.
The regular if you can get a fucking mouse?
Right.
Yep.
Yeah.
If you anything at that matter, anything shaped other than a fucking rectangle.
I thought you were gonna go another direction. I heard rect. I was like, what?
Okay. Let's look at what we got left.
Still
how
are
we feeling? We've still got four faces on the board. I think I'm going to knock out Bubbles from the Powerpuff Girls.
Easy.
Yeah.
She doesn't even have gumball eyes.
Yeah, I was about to ask. Yeah. Are the white gumballs? It doesn't look like it.
Oh,
so no. If you don't got gumballs and you're a face...
You're going to make a Powerpuff Girl ice cream of Bubbles and not give her bubblegum eyes?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Offensive.
What kind of communist country are we living in?
Blue Bunny should be ashamed. I'm writing my Blue Bunny congressman.
What a fucking disaster. What a disaster. All right. I am going to take out a classic here. For no other reason than the fact that I can get a fucking grip of these at the grocery store anytime I want. But that means that this is not special, so get the fuck out of here with an ice cream sandwich.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Choco Taco.
No.
Because you can also get those at the grocery store anytime you want, right?
Not then!
Used to be special.
Well, fuck my ice cream sandwich.
But you know what?
What we've learned as Lee's taken out both ice cream sandwiches is that Lee just doesn't like an ice cream sandwich.
No, you know, I love...
It hurts my teeth when I bite into them.
Well, no,
what the fuck?
No, ice cream sandwiches are super soft. Are you thinking
But they're
about...
really cold.
The cookie one is super hard to get into sometimes.
That's very true, yeah.
See, but I would agree. Unless I get myself my screwball and I've got like an extra 50 cents and I can get an ice cream sandwich, I wouldn't generally get an ice cream sandwich from the ice cream truck. But get a box of those in the house, and yeah, I'll have one of those every night for a week.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Sometimes if you're really depressed, you can put peanut butter on them. Oh, buddy. That's great. That's a good time. All right, so it's starting to make sense. So Lee doesn't like ice cream sandwiches because they hurt his teeth when he bites into them. So now I understand why he likes Choco Tacos so much, because of their soggy, disappointing-ass shell. And so I'm going to say goodbye to the Choco Taco at number 17.
Oh, wow.
I see. He's trying to make everyone use their saves. He's gonna go. He's gunning for everyone's number one.
This is win-win for me because I won.
Choco Taco is the Punisher Warzone of this ranking.
It is, because if it doesn't go out this round, Mahoney's picking it next round.
Lee, in our private message, like when we decided that this was going to be the exercise we were gonna do, and he's like, No contest. Choco Taco number one. Why would he play his hand like that and ruin Choco Taco's chances? So,
Lee, you using your save?
Oof, the Hang silence. On.
Lee, are you here?
My shit was muted.
Been there.
But no. No, we using the same because the Choco Taco is fucking magic. Like,
oh, all right.
I meant it. Like, if you were like any day of the fucking week, twice on Sunday, what ice cream treat do you want? Oh, fucking Choco Taco all day. That's where it's at.
Okay. Let's see here. Hold on.
Zero in the chat also provided evidence on Discord that the bubble bar Powerpuff Girl does come with bubblegum eyes. But still, I think bubbles fell at the perfect spot.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh.
All right. So with Choco Taco saved.
Bet your ass Choco Taco saved.
All right.
He says, how about Choco Taco?
Then I'm going to drop another thing I find overhyped and disappointing. The Chocolate Eclair Bar. Why would I ever choose this when I have strawberry shortcake looking right at me?
Mm-hmm. I'll agree to that.
I like the chocolate one.
The chocolate one's all right, but the strawberry is far superior.
Yeah, yep. We got a box, you know, preparing for this night, we got a box of, like, a variety pack, and it was cookie sandwiches, strawberry shortcake, but not chocolate eclair, Oreo in the same style of the strawberry shortcake.
Oh, hello. And,
I think really like very similar flavors to the chocolate eclair, but it just looks better. It's, you know, it's that dark, dark brown, sounds almost better. Black.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if I went up to the ice cream truck and I asked for strawberry and they said, we're out, but we got chocolate, I'm looking at the menu one more time before I order chocolate.
Like, I like the texture of those.
Yes. Nice and soft.
They're really just satisfying to eat from a lot of perspectives. It's nice.
Smart.
It's good when you get like a nice fresh one.
Yeah.
Some when they get like kind of soggy.
And
you know what I mean? Like it may have stayed out like 3 minutes too long.
Sometimes the ice cream, especially the chocolate eclair, can get icy. You know, it's not necessarily ice cream, but it gets a little... Like almost like a freezer burn. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It feels, it screams like fifth grade lunch.
Yeah. Yeah, sure does.
Get a rectangle pizza. Yeah.
You love the word rectangle tonight, sir.
Fuck yeah. All
right. Well, what rectangle are you going to take off the board next?
Rectangle? Hardly knew him. Well, my pick almost kind of changes a little bit because I was made aware that the Powerpuff Girl does have eyes, because for the sins of their father, Sonic was getting the fucking boot because Blue Bunny made both.
Oh, I see.
But then I was informed the eyes are bubblegum. But of the faces, I would rather have Turtles or Spider-Man, so I'm going to go ahead and stay with my
decision. I'm using my save.
Oh!
You're welcome, Mahoney.
You,
You know what I like about the Sonic bar is it looks bigger than the turtle in the Spider-Man bar.
Yeah, Sonic was big, and I loved the flavor, and that's just that was what I would always get when it was available.
All right. Well, my bad. I didn't mean to offend.
Only two saves left on the board.
My son's first grade class was had like an ice cream thing, and the fucking Sonic ice cream bar is a hot ticket item amongst children even today.
Sonic's great.
All right, my bad.
Italian ice just slinking into the corner over there, being like, nothing to see here.
No, don't look over here.
Don't mind me.
No shit ice cream
either. Fuck Spider-Man, am I right?
I'm just some ice that stood next to a lemon for a little while.
That chocolate taco's got way too much sugar. I want to cut that one and make your parents proud.
Crunch
dibs, more like cook dibs.
Wait, what?
Get the strawberry shortcake out of my fucking face.
It's not your pick!
Okay, repick. Whoa. Somebody changed the draft order.
It's not even almost your pick.
He used his save.
You're like three people away.
Yeah.
I picked Solomon. Kelly saved it.
You're drunk.
He's drunk on power now. He's like, motherfucker.
I heard Kelly talking, and I thought Kelly made a pick, and I'm fucking crazy.
Oh, my God.
No, Kelly saved it.
Disaster.
I promise you guys.
I promise I'm not high.
Did your pool guy come today? Your deck guy?
That really sounds like something someone who's high would say.
Yeah.
Did you get your pool clean? Did he come? He swing by and fucking make sure that chlorine was good?
Did he pull a frog out of your filter and say, lick this?
I don't know what the fuck happened.
He's like, dude, it's funny. I cleaned your pool, found this acid.
He's like, anyways, I'm getting rid of Electra.
Yeah. All right.
I don't know what happened. I have no idea what the fuck happened.
I'm going to stick on my theme.
You just came out of nowhere. Like, it wasn't even time for a pick. You were just like, strawberry shortcake, get out of my face.
Yeah. Here's Wonderwall.
All right. So just to make things easier, I doubled up our names on the right hand side. They can't see this at home, but all of our names line up with what will be our picks. So.
Oh, there we go.
Okay, perfect.
That's an excellent idea. Oh, look at that guy.
All right, Jose.
Well, Lee just changed it.
Can't put one of these out of their misery.
Okay, so I'm going to stay with my faces if Sonic is staying.
I really thought you were going to try and cut Sonic again.
Yeah, if Sonic is staying, I'm cutting Sonic. Okay, so my bad, Kelly. Spider-Man, get the fuck out.
Oh, man.
Film star Spider-Man ice cream.
I know.
Go suck it in the corner with Iron Man.
That's kind of wild, man. That's a classic.
And one of these faces got to go. And you know what face I'm not picking.
Right. And we had the discussion before the show. And it's like, all these ones with the faces, they taste the same. They all got bubble gum. It's just the novelty of it.
If I'm choosing any face, I'm taking that Ninja Turtle face for sure.
Exactly.
All right,
but I do see the point of the Sonic does look
bigger. Yeah,
like you're getting bigger. More for your buck. That Spider-Man's the smallest of all of them.
Yeah, right. For sure.
All right, Mahoney sold me on this one, so my next.
Well,
pick...
the Spider-Man, all the whites of the eyes should be bubblegum. If you're gonna cut me, if you're gonna skip me on ice cream,
oh my god,
fucking hit me up on that bubblegum tip.
And doesn't it just feel like it's small? Like, not only does it look smaller, but I bet it is smaller because they know that because it's Spider-Man, they're gonna sell it no matter what size it is.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
No, it's. I'm just angry at it in general.
I can make two Spider-Mans and sell it for the same.
For one Sonic.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. So with my next pick, I did not grow up in Brooklyn in the 1940s. So sorry, Italian ice. You got to go.
But think about Mario. I got to pay my partner rent.
See, but like Italian ice is good though.
Italian ice is great, but fine. I would never see it on my ice cream truck.
Like, but I got no sugar.
If I was eating Italian ice, I'm sure I would enjoy it. But if somebody came up to me and was like, "Hey, you want some Italian ice?" There's a good chance I'd be like, "No." Like, no, I don't.
No, yeah, but why?
Because
I mean, it's different if you give me other options. But if you what if somebody's some Italian like, ice, I'm fucking yeah.
What if I had to choose like, between Italian ice or nothing, half the time I would choose nothing.
Do you want Italian ice or do you want to eat a cartoon character's face?
That's wild, though. Yeah, but nothing. You would choose nothing over.
Yeah, I would choose. No thanks. I'll just keep looking at my phone. Wow.
That's what he chooses most of the time.
Yeah. It is a wild
sorry,
stand.
Sir. The Italian ice does not do a dance.
Yeah. Like no thanks. I'm gonna go watch Italian Hank Green get canceled on the internet. But thanks for offering.
But what's like? What don't you like about it that much that you'd rather have?
It's just
nothing.
It's a lot of effort. It takes a while. Like, it's not quick.
See, I think that's good. It does
sticky.
Take a while. But it costs the same as a fucking Klondike bar. And you're getting more
it's
you're getting longevity out of it. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's clean. Yeah. It's, yeah.
Yeah.
How do you use cups?
What do you... It's definitely sticky. Don't try to tell me Italian ice is not sticky. Italian ice is
Fuck
a universally
up.
Sticky experience.
No. Not universal.
All right, for my next one, I'm cutting something that I really think should not have made it to the top half
of the list. Oh, if you
fucking
cut Sonic, I'm gonna be so pissed.
No, I am cutting the Chip Witch.
The Chip Witch?
Wow.
Oh my god. I am saving the Chip Witch.
Oh.
Absolutely.
It's just unpleasant to eat.
Oh my god, you're not eating the right kind of Chip Witch.
Mahoney! You're going to save the Chip Witch when you know Lee has a boner to eliminate Strawberry Shortcake.
That's fine. Okay. I would take a Chip Witch over basically anything on this list.
Really? Okay.
Absolutely.
I see. Most of the time, Chip Witch is an unpleasant experience unless it's nice and soft.
Oh yeah.
My God. I don't know where you're getting your Chip Witches.
From the fucking ice cream truck.
Yeah. Completely
they're always... too hard, and then the chips are spiky.
No.
I'm against Mahoney on Italian ice, but I'm with him on this.
It's like eating a gravel sandwich.
Give it to me. I'll eat mine. I'll eat yours. I'll eat Jason Nye's.
All right. Then I think I'm going to cut Crunch Dibs.
Yeah.
Crunch
Dibs. Because I don't associate that with an ice cream truck at all.
Did you put that on the list?
No, okay. I don't think I did.
Okay,
so I put it on there to kill it.
That's fine. That's fine.
I put that on the list because it's really good.
They are great.
They're delightful.
Good, but yeah, they're not ice cream truck food, though.
Right. I mean, they could be these days.
Yeah,
maybe possibly.
Now they're movie food.
Yeah.
All right, time for a Strawberry Shortcake.
Dude, pick Sonic.
I might let Strawberry Shortcake go just because I fucked it up so bad a minute ago. Let's.
As an apology?
Yeah, just because I feel bad.
My bad.
Yeah, not to nitty gritty now. Okay, so it's got to be Strawberry Shortcake then, because the rest of these are fucking champions.
Well, I don't know about the rest of them. There's a couple on here
It should have gone in the. It should have gone before 25.
Jose, is Jose the only one with a save left?
Jose is the only one with a save left.
I have a save.
Okay.
I will control the fate of ice cream.
Strawberry Shortcut.
Now, once I figure out what your favorite thing is. I know it's not this, because nobody likes these. Push-ups. Fuck out of here.
I never
should have made it past 25.
I do love a push-up.
Push-ups are good. Push-ups
no
are
one
solid.
Loves a push-up.
I would always
for 25 cents?
If I wasn't...
Fucking...
I like a push-up.
He's worried about the cost of their ice cream truck ice cream.
A child.
No, it's not the cost of the ice
children.
Cream truck. It's what can I get for the most... How can I get the most out of what I'm coming up to the truck with?
No. I don't care if I can get 1,000 push-ups for $1. I don't want it. I don't want a single one. Again, if you came up to me and were like, you want a push-up? No thanks.
He's like, that's just a harder working Italian ice.
I'd rather just stare at the ground. Like, thanks.
Like, I feel like that's, I don't agree with that take, but at the same time, I don't even know the last time I had a push-up.
It's been a while.
I don't know the last time I had one, but I guarantee you I didn't enjoy it.
He's like, you're telling me you're putting Italian ice in a cylinder and I have to push it towards my face?
It's not even Italian ice. I don't even know what it is.
It's like a sherbet almost.
Yeah, it's like a sherbet.
They're traditionally like orange.
You got to work on it to get it going, though. You got to start it up. You got to prime it.
Hey, you got to do that with me, too.
Oh!
It's that good old classic jerking off Jason Nye's comedy.
Hey!
Put that in the intro.
Came for the ice cream, stayed for the jerking.
Oh, my God.
My pick?
Yeah,
yep. Your pick. Your pick. Every pick is Lee's pick.
Nip and Dots, get the fuck out of here.
Oh,
yeah.
Like you're all right, but you don't. I would never order Dippin' Dots off an ice cream truck.
No, Dippin' Dots are great, but I don't think
you need Dippin' Dots from the Dippin' Dots man.
Yeah, if
Dippin'
you
Dots
find
you're only getting as a novelty,
right? Like, yeah, if you
and they're probably overpriced on the truck. Get the fuck.
Oh, they're definitely overpriced.
If you get Dippin' Dots off of an ice cream truck, you are in the rich part of town, and you need to go.
Yeah,
yeah, and it probably costs $8.
You're like, one Dippin' Dots, please. And then the kid behind you is like, 1,000 push-ups, if you don't mind.
Nothing better than a pocket push-up.
All right.
God damn it.
I'm going to go with this one because, again, it's kind of, it probably wouldn't have been on your average 1980s ice cream truck because especially they just only recently started selling them in stores. I'm going to go with the Mickey Mouse bar at number 10. Classic shape,
they're
classic flavors. No,
he said, I will take out all the fucking vanilla covered
chocolate. Top 10 is a good showing for the Mickey Mouse bar.
Yeah, I thought about taking out Screwball myself just because I don't know if it deserves top 10 higher than number 10, but I'm going to let it ride, baby. Let's see.
Yeah, it's kind of like, you know, when you got to take your own family out.
Yeah.
Right before a disaster.
Yeah. Well, it's surviving another one because I'm taking Chipwich now.
Oh, my God. That's such the wrong answer, but whatever.
No, that sounded completely out of spite. Don't make me fucking pull Sonic. You can't save it now.
I've never had one that was, like, just not horrible.
I honestly don't even understand what you're talking about because I've never had a bad one. Like, it doesn't even make any sense to me.
Like, we got that.
The guys that are putting them in the packages are like, Mahoney, Kelly. Mahoney, Kelly.
We got this.
They're rock hard and they're sharp. But I'm like, what the fuck are you eating?
We got this multi-pack.
I agree with Kelly, actually.
We got this multi-pack of ice cream, and one of the things was cookie sandwiches. And I was floored when I opened one of the cookie sandwiches, and the cookies and the ice cream were both soft and edible right out of the box. I was
like a hockey puck,
blown away.
What the fuck? That's what they're like all the time.
No.
They are.
I'm used to the everything's really hard, and then somehow all of the points of the chocolate chips are facing out, so they can stab you as you're trying to eat it.
That's so.
Yeah,
but
you gotta eat it like at the side of your mouth. Really get those good chomping teeth on there. They're fucking
hard.
Well,
we know you have very sensitive little teethers.
But yeah. Mahoney.
It feels like you should be wearing a gimp suit while you eat
it. I'll tell you this. It's number 9. We're complaining about it. But it's still delicious, and I will eat every last bite of it.
Yeah, I you know, it is what it is. I'm more upset that you don't have good ones. And I just don't understand.
So are we.
That's just not the experience that I have. It'd be like if I was like, oh, I don't like the Spider-Man bars because every time I bite into it, I crack a tooth. And you'd be like, what? Like, that's not how those go. I don't like ice cream sandwiches because they always burn my mouth.
they're always too hot.
Yeah, like, it just doesn't make any sense to me.
I don't like the Snickers ice cream bar because it always gives me herpes.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, next up. Taking out the Screwball.
Hey, yeah. It made it to the top 10.
You can only save it once. Yeah. But yeah.
You made too far.
You fought for it and you made top 10. That's respect.
I needed to throw myself on that grenade for the screwball.
I fist bump you on the screwball. I'm a fan of a big screwball. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a fucking Italian ice with gum.
I don't know if I ever had one of those, but when I was looking for the pictures, they have screwballs with two gumballs in them. And that's wild.
Oh, shit.
Game changer.
Screwballs with two balls is close as you can get to an actual penis.
Is it called screwballs?
Adios, Choco Taco. You soggy rip. Motherfucker.
It's so funny. Goat said the same thing I did. Goat was like, it's just this Choco Taco and 29 other bullshit.
It's wild.
It's a bad take. Fucking, like, they're delicious.
Like,
do they
make Choco Tacos in Murfreesboro or something? Like, what's going on?
They're so good, man.
I could understand enjoying Choco Tacos if every time I bit into a Chipwich, it was as hard as gravel. So,
is there like a Choco Taco lobby in Middle Tennessee?
Maybe it's something they put in the fucking water down here. I don't know, man. But they're fucking.
I think
delicious.
We get it up here too, because I fucking love a Choco Taco.
So like, good.
It's so weird.
They're good.
I know I've had Choco Tacos in my life before, but they've always been unremarkable to the point where I'd never like go back to be like, oh yeah, fuck yeah, Choco Taco. But like,
the presentation is great, man. It's got like the hard outside.
Nope.
The waffle wrap means it's not gonna fall apart on you. It's not gonna fucking get your fingers all fucked up, and it's a superior chocolate coating that stays intact as well. So it's just everything's where you want it to be when you want it to be there.
See, if I remember correctly, Choco Tacos fall apart pretty easily and spectacularly all over your hands.
They slide like a burger that's not put together right.
Yeah. I just had one earlier in the week.
Choco Tacos.
Yeah, I was going to say, I did not have that experience.
Yeah, no, I've never really had them fall apart on me.
But I think that's also made that's another one that, like the strawberry shortcake, if it gets soggy and it's not like nice and kind of frozen together a little bit.
Yeah, you got to pick them right off the vine and then eat them with their fresh.
Yeah, you got to go. There's no shelf life. Like, if you took it out of the fridge, open that bitch up and devour it. Stop fucking around.
All right.
But if you let it sit and it gets soggy,
My pick? I love you, honey, but I don't respect you anymore.
I can deal with that.
Jose, you still haven't used your save, right? You saving it for the very end?
He's saving it for the very end.
I'm saving it for one that I want to save. There hasn't been one pick that I'm willing to jump on a grenade for.
Well, I mean, we're top five, so like they're top five one way or the other.
Oh, no. It's going to win.
Okay.
I'm going fucking, like, it's good. It's all right. But out of everything on the board, I wouldn't order this over those. I might get it if I'm going grocery shopping. Dreamsicle, creamsicle, peacesicle.
Yeah.
I saw that.
Honestly, I think things flavored like a dreamsicle are better than the dreamsicle itself.
I think you're correct.
I agree.
Like, you give me a dreamsicle soda, fuck yeah.
Or like shake, milkshake.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Like,
yeah,
it's
like
good.
Fucking Arby's has one right now that's awesome.
Dude, don't give me more reason to go back to Arby's.
Dude, go to Arby's. They
I
have
fucking
meats.
Love Arby's. I will go Arby's to Arby's once a week if my wife lets me.
Hell yeah. Mary, let the man go to Arby's.
Comic-Con Arby's.
Mary, why won't you let him go to Arby's?
She Mary, lets me let go, to Arby's, go to Arby's, but I don't need to be going to Arby's once a week and getting a creamsicle shake.
Yeah,
okay?
Mary, let the man go to Arby's and get a creamsicle shake. Let my good friend Jason Nyes go to Arby's and get a creamsicle shake. And you tell
Jason
them.
Jason Nyes didn't shit or say fuck for 4 days. Let the man have a creamsicle shake.
Yeah, you tell them my husband Jason Nyes deserves a creamsicle shake.
Send him with a note. To whom it may concern, please give my husband, Mr. Jason Nyes, one creamsicle shake.
I was informed you have the meats. Please give my young adult son a creamsicle shake and whatever meats he may desire. All right, so we're down to the top five. This is what we got left. We got drumstick. We got Oreo sandwich. We got Ninja Turtle bar, Sonic bar, and Snickers ice cream.
Two bars in the top five is one bar too many, but them's the break.
For the same reasons that I criticize the Chip Witch, at number five, I'm going to pick the Oreo sandwich.
Yeah.
Wow.
I can see that.
It doesn't have the spikes to it, though, so that's how it got higher.
No.
And I think oftentimes the cookie on the Oreo sandwich is softer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's not like Oreo-y. You know what I mean? Like sometimes
it's cookies and cream.
You have a better chance of getting a soggier Oreo cookie. Crisp.
If it's soggy, then it's just like you dunked it in milk.
And I want a little bit of crunch. Like I love. That was almost my one, but like, I can let it be a five.
Really?
It's the one I had you pegged for. Now I'm trying to figure out which one is your one.
It's got to be the Ninja Turtle bar.
For real.
I like to keep Mahoney thinking.
I guess. Yeah. I suppose it must be.
Okay. But yeah, but see, like the complaints about the the
Chip Witch.
I've almost had more of those experiences with an Oreo cookie.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Uh huh. Sure.
So I don't get it at all. I've never had a bad Chip Witch or a bad Oreo cookie. Like, I've never in my life, and I've eaten a million of them.
I mean, it just depends on how, like, you know, if you get it out of one of those,
how deep your freezers.
Yeah. Did the person before you not close it enough? And
I would understand that, except having eaten a million of them, I have had them in every imaginable scenario. And I've never had a bad one.
Okay. What about, like, out of the freezer at a gas station?
Yeah.
Well, that's what I'm talking about.
Those are the worst offenders for a hard cookie ice cream sandwich.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I've had people are dicks. They don't close the thing.
Ice cream vending machine cookie sandwiches.
Oh, shit,
like,
yeah.
From the grocery store, from a ice cream, like, you walk up and order it at, like, a theme park. Like, if I can get a cookie sandwich, I'm getting one.
Theme park, like, cookie sandwiches at Disney are hard as rocks, too. You know what? Mahoney, anytime we are in the same vicinity as one another, whenever we're hanging out, anywhere we go, we're getting two
cookie sandwiches.
Anytime we can, and just test
them
in
half.
Yep.
Yeah, come in half so both of you can try
No.
There's no like which one's better.
Lady and the Tramp.
Cut them both in half.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. There you go. Right. Yeah.
Some of those you're not going to be able to cut in half.
Yeah.
Good fucking luck.
You'll see. I'm going to touch them. They're going to be perfect. You're going to be like, this is the best ice cream I've ever had.
That's your new TikTok video, cutting ice cream sandwiches.
Oh, man. Mahoney has the chocolate touch. Okay, I'm really struggling over here with my pick.
Hey, cut it, dude. Get the fuck out of here, Sonic. Do it. You do it. Put him down. Poke him right in his fucking bubblegum eyes. Bite his fucking nose off.
They can't be two bars next to each other. Two and three. One and two. Like, it's just...
Well, they gotta Kelly's break not going to pick Sonic. He's not going to pick Sonic. He wants Sonic to go as far as possible, even if
it's
one space ahead.
Get the turtle out of here.
Ahead.
Yeah,
I'm
getting the turtle out of here. I love that Sonic bar too much.
Doesn't faze me one bit.
Yeah, I knew he was after the one I thought.
Look at that. Yeah, but look at the ice cream
ratio
footprint compared. Yeah, like if Raphael's head was as big up top as it was below, now we're talking. Like, give me Raphael with an afro. And you're kind of reaching the same ice cream footprint as Sonic.
Like, at least give me a bandana knot.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh, there you go. Yep. That could fucking even it out. Yeah. Add a bandana knot and I'm saving it. Sorry, Turtle. And Raphael's eyes aren't even blue.
Yeah, that's true.
They're hazel.
Top six.
Okay.
Teams.
All right, Lee.
All right.
I just know this is going to be some weird nonsense.
Strawberry shortcake.
Yeah. Strawberry shortcake. Re-get the fuck out of here.
I got a very clear choice here, in my opinion.
It's got to be the Sonic Bar.
Good call.
Yeah, Sonic Bar is showing. Next.
I'm all right with
Sonic
that.
Bar. Yep, type three. Yep, yep. Got to be Sonic Bar next.
Yeah, and if you're done, Lee, Kelly, Nyes, if you're done picking, move your cursor over to the side so we can get a clean board.
Well, and that does make
someone's Sonic on an Oreo sandwich, and it's not me. I don't know who.
Who?
Jose, you on Oreo sandwich?
I'm very interested to see what happened next. I feel like there's a very clear winner between these two. They're both excellent, but I feel like there's a very clear winner.
This makes the Sonic Bar the clear-cut bubblegum face character, which I can agree with.
Yeah.
Sweet hair.
And top sweet three hair for the face character is a good place.
I tell you what, I want one. I want one right now. I've never had
one. There should be a face character in the top three of ice cream truck treats, because like that's a staple.
We're doing the Lord's work over here.
Yeah. Maybe not one, but top three, mad respect.
I want that gum that loses flavor within 5 seconds.
Yeah. By the time the gum only lasts as long as you can hear the ice cream truck's music.
Yeah. But for that 5 seconds, it's delicious.
Mm-hmm. Kind of like, remember that zebra gum? What was the fuck was
fruit
it?
Stripe.
Fruit stripe gum.
Yeah. Fruit stripe gum. Yeah. And it lasted
for like...
You
got five chews, you're done.
A single bite. Boom,
count
done.
The stripes on your piece of gum, and that's how many bites of flavor you have.
All right.
So, Mahoney.
Final two. Mahoney is going to be the decider.
No,
well,
Jose
still
has
got
his save.
Jose still got his save, except I have a pretty good idea of which one Jose wants.
Well, it doesn't matter. I'm going to get it.
Yeah, I understand.
I'm going to fucking get it. I'm getting it.
Getting well, what's his.
If it were up to me, the one that I would dump off at why won't it go here? The one I would dump off at spot number two, drumstick.
Yeah.
Nope.
Unbelievable.
Nope.
Yeah.
No.
Nope.
I'm with Jose.
You can go ahead and take drumstick right the fuck off of two. Go ahead and put it on one and write whatever the fuck you put a tie and ice it to. Drumstick, take it home.
Wow.
Drumstick over Snickers ice cream?
Yeah. I would buy drumstick more than I would buy Snickers ice cream, but Snickers ice cream is fantastic.
Any fucking day of the week.
What
even
an upset.
If I'm going into, if I go to the store right now, I'm coming home with a box of multi-flavored drumsticks.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Regular vanilla, the chocolate, and the fucking caramel.
Love the caramel. Yep. Need the caramel every time. Give me a box of all caramel.
Yeah. Mm.
Yeah. No, drumstick. I think, all day, all night.
Yeah, I
and
think
the fucking
you're right.
Cone
yeah,
is
I was,
great. I've never had
I was
a
on
bad
for Snickers.
Drumstick.
Never. And I was on for Snickers, but then now that we're talking about it, now that I'm here, now that I've had time to make peace with it, maybe Snickers is more of a gas station treat.
Well, if you think about it,
I'm not a fan of the Snickers ice cream as much.
If you think about it, there besides the cone, it's all the same ingredients.
Yeah.
But drumstick is the better experience.
Yeah, and that cone, it just stays so crispy.
And then you get the chocolate
you
at the bottom.
You want to talk about
that
cone that never disappoints?
That wad of chocolate at the bottom, too.
Oh, yeah.
You get the experience of being able to lick an ice cream cone. You can bite the shit off the top of it. Lick an ice cream cone. You got the caramel in the center. Eat the cone.
You get the caramel. It just busts in your mouth.
Not in your hand. It don't be leaking because the bottom's, like, sealed in chocolate. So, like, the ice cream doesn't leak out. I mean, sometimes out of the bottom, if you're on some weak-ass ice cream game, but...
All right, well, let's recap our list. I will start. I'll do the first six. So number 30, we got Sunday Cup, 29, Klondike Bar, 28, Neapolitan Ice Cream Sandwich, 27, WWF Ice Cream Bar, 26, Snow Cone, and 25, King Cone.
Kelly, you take the next.
24, we got Fudgesicle. 23, Rocket Pop. 22, Bubblegum Swirl. 21, Chocolate Banana Firecracker. 20, Vanilla Bar. And 19, Bubbles Bar.
All right, Lee?
18, Ice Cream Sandwich. 17, the Chocolate Eclair Bar. 16, the Spider-Man Ice Cream Bar, who had his very own cameo in a major motion picture, for Christ's sake. Number 15, Italian Ice. And number 6, more with Theater Jam, the Crunch Dibs.
Okay, that was number 14. You also have to read number 13, Strawberry Shortcake.
I was about to read 13, Strawberry Shortcake. Get the fuck out of here.
Sure. Sure, buddy. Sure you were.
We almost signed out. Thanks for joining us.
Mahoney,
listen next week.
Mahoney, pick up his slack. What's going on here?
Number 12. Number 12 is
Lee, you're a joy when
you
get
weed dealer. Number 11 is the real number 12 is the push-up pop, which it's just disappointing.
Come on, there's not time for commentary here.
Number 11, Dippin' Dots. Number 10, Mickey Mouse Bar. Number 9, Chipwich. Number 8, Screwball. Number 7, the Choco Taco.
Take us home, Jose.
Coming in, number 6, Dreamsicle Creamsicle. Get the fuck out. Oreo Sandwich at 5, Ninja Turtle Bar at 4. The top 3 standing on the podium representing the faces with bubblegum eyes. Sonic, I got a lot of fucking ice cream hair. The Hedgehog Bar. Number 2.
Representing the faces.
Yeah. Number 2, Snickers Ice Cream. Yeah, but you ain't no number 1 drumstick.
Wow.
The fucking king. King of the ice cream truck treats.
The king of this shit.
Ranked MDK by the number 1 wrestling podcast in the U.S.
We did it, you guys.
We fucking did
it. I think this is the definitive list.
Yeah. Objectively correct.
I'm happy with it.
You know what you'll never find anywhere on the internet? A list of the top 31 ice cream truck treats.
My top 2 made the top 5, so I can handle that. I was keeping Mahoney on his toes.
I thought you were after the Oreo sandwich and the Snickers ice cream. I never would have pegged you for a drumstick boy.
Yeah. No, but you, the drumstick boy, 7 days a week. 425 a year.
425?
Above and beyond.
Fucking
the recommended
stupid.
365.
God,
fucking ridiculous!
This is an excellent time.
You are right about Oreo sandwich, though. Like Oreo sandwich, like it was the mix. And look, they're right; they're next to each other, right on top. Bam!
We should be the number 1 podcast on the planet, you guys.
It's true.
Strawberry Shortcake was like my dark horse, and Lee fucking destroyed that.
Yeah, Lee was like,
I wasn't going to save Strawberry Shortcake.
Lee said, nobody likes grapes, nobody likes Strawberry Shortcake. I think that one might be the most controversial that it didn't make the top 10. Or did it?
No, it did not. It went out.
Yeah.
13.
I would have put that in the top 10. One of those bars should have gone earlier. Sonic or Ninja Turtles.
Yeah, I'll agree. Because that I would rather have Strawberry Shortcake at 4 than the Ninja Turtle bar.
Yeah.
Well, Lee was making sure that wasn't going to happen.
Man, clearly.
Said, fuck that. But I couldn't. No, see, if I would have used my save on fucking Strawberry Shortcake, Snickers comes in number 1.
Yeah. Snickers is amazing.
Man, it ain't no drumstick, though. No. You give me a box of Snickers, box of drumsticks.
The most disappointing part of this entire list is learning that all of you have never had a good Chipwich.
Yeah.
No,
this
hey,
is very
I,
much like the other week when we
you
learned you've never had a pear. Like,
or fresh good and plenties.
Yeah.
I like the fuck out of a Chipwich.
So next week, we're coming back. We're doing back-to-back food toppings, top topics, you guys. So next week, we're talking about your top 6 chain restaurants at a time when chain restaurants are at an unprecedented workforce shortage for reasons that are far too complicated for us to talk about on a podcast. Instead, we'll just talk about which ones we like.
People so tip like shit. That's what it comes down to.
And get paid like shit, too.
Well, yeah.
I get treated like shit.
Oh my god.
So what, cop boys, get the fuck out of here.
Damn. Oh man.
I'm quite keen on comic books. Especially the ones about superheroes.
The problem with comics is it keeps breaking stuff.
So, Kelly.
Lee.
This fucking Spider-Man's, right?
This fucking Spider-Man.
This fucking Spider-Man's with this fucking life.
You like
and
everything
death
to take
shit.
Too long? Lee?
Oh my god. Like, this fucking tablet bullshit story took so long, they managed to put another too long story in the middle of it. Like, yeah. That's how long this shit took.
Yeah, that's the crazy thing is, like, it felt like we were finally just getting somewhere with the Kindred stuff, and then we got to deal with this fucking tablet.
But Kindred is also in there in the background, so we still
yeah,
there,
but,
guess.
Like, he's been doing the same thing for the past, like, 5 issues, which is sitting in a block, and every once in a while someone makes him yell.
And then it's also taking so long, they had to fucking finish it in a goddamn special. That is really like an extra fucking issue, an oversized issue that's also too fucking long. And it's been, I feel like it's been a year. And all of this to get the fucking rose back?
Yeah. Yeah, that was not the payoff I was expecting and not the payoff I wanted.
Because you think Wilson wants to bring back Vanessa, obviously, you know, because he wants his wife back. But he's like, no, the reason that you died and I wasn't here because I, you know, you had to kill our son to protect me or some shit, which happened way back like in the Bendis years. Vanessa shot Richard. And then it's like, yeah, I'll fucking use this magic tablet, which came out of nowhere. And I use it to bring the rose back. And like, all right, so that's what all this was for.
Was anyone and, clamoring for the rose to come back?
No. Yeah. Yeah, real fucking weird. Real fucking strange that that's where they went with this. It took too long, and they, you know, reset
all the
shit.
There's no reason to bring
the
rose back, because the rose is just some dude in a mask. Like, make someone else the rose, you know? Like, boom, well, he's back.
They framed it as, like, him trying to honor what would have been Vanessa's wish. Like, so, like, oh, if I brought you back, you would have, you know, been furious because I, you know, had a chance to bring back our son and I didn't, so I'm gonna honor your wish, I'm gonna bring back our son. I'm like, all right, okay.
Which but no one gives a funny. Shit about your son.
No one gives half a shit. And like, it's also kind of funny that he came back to the great beyond wearing his dumbass rose mask.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
Well, that's kind of a thing. And also he's completely ignoring his brand new magic son that Mike Murdoch gave him.
Yeah.
It's a damn shame. Wilson, what are you doing? You already got a son. They got magicked into existence.
Yeah.
Just boy, what an anticlimactic payoff. And then, like, you know, all the shit with Boomerang, they just washed away. And
that was fucking, really disappointing.
Yeah. Because, like, he was kind of a hoop. It's kind of fun watching, yeah. You know, watching his weird little redemption arc and all this shit. And it's like, yeah, nah, he's just a piece of shit.
Anyway, yeah, no, that was disappointing. I enjoyed his whole story arc up until then.
Real weird. Just real fucking weird. And God, was it long. It was so long.
Yeah.
Ridiculous. Yeah. Got anything else we're talking about?
Let me look through. I'm fully caught up on Savage Dragon now.
Wow. Yeah, you are.
I really enjoy it. Like, I enjoy it a lot, but I don't.
You read 30 years worth of comics almost in like three
yeah,
months.
But I don't know if I would ever recommend it to someone.
Explain.
Like, it's, I like it. Like, it's, I think it's good, but I don't think it's objectively good. Like, it's very much,
I understand that. I can appreciate that.
Yeah. It's very much like my shit.
Like Venom. Like kind the of, Venom yeah. movie. The Venom movie is not an objectively good movie, but I sure do love it.
Yeah. It's very much my shit. Like, I like long narratives done by, like, one creator and just seeing their whole story play out over a number of years. And with Savage Dragon taking place in real time, that adds to that. And I really enjoy that aspect of it. And, like, there's a bunch of issues where it's just him doing, like, wait, what if Savage Dragon was Commandy? And I'm like, okay, cool. That's what I like. I like this okay. kind of stuff. And it's just dumb comic-y bullshit. And, you know, it's not the greatest writing. It's not the greatest art. But it's in tune with my specific sensibilities as a comic reader. But again, like, it's so much. I don't know if I could recommend it to anybody. Because eventually you're going to get to some issues where there's a bunch of weird cum jokes. And, like, I don't know. Like, that stuff's weird. I could do without it, but, like, it wasn't going to make me stop reading the book. But again, because that stuff is in there, I don't think I could recommend it to anybody. Because it's like, what are you going to do? Oh, this book's really good, but eventually you're going to have to deal with a lot of cum. Like, eventually Malcolm Dragon is going to blast his wife off of his dick with so much cum, it throws her into the air. She lands on the ground, and it dribbles out of her into her mouth. Great read.
Comics are for kids.
You should definitely pick it up.
Like, oh my god.
Yeah, like, that happens in there. So again, it's like, I can't recommend it, but I did really enjoy it. It's a good ride, and it's fun just watching those characters grow over the course of 20, 30, almost 30 years.
I think that is a very honest take, Kelly.
Yeah, I completely understand. The most fair I can be.
I respect it.
Is there really a scene where Savage Dragon blasts his wife off of him with a torrent of cum?
I read that. Yeah, I read that one because I had issue to see what it was about. Sure enough.
I remember them talking about that in an issue of Wizard.
Wow.
No, that didn't happen in Wizard.
No, this happened just a couple of years ago.
Yeah, this is very recent.
Oh, that's weird. Well, I remember it.
It's your Yoda drilling through the wall.
you're talking about us. Kelly and I are the wizard in this scenario.
Yeah. But yeah, like, there's, by the time where we're at now, is there has been like four different Savage Dragons through different various timelines and shit. And, like, again, currently it is not even the same character anymore.
Which I did not know that. That's kind of wild.
Yeah, now it's Malcolm Dragon, who is the original dragon's son. The original dragon died.
Spoilers, Kelly. Jesus.
You'd find out eventually. No. But also, the original dragon is kind of back, because the original, back in Graphic Fantasy, which was Eric Larson's fan comic from the 80s, featured Paul Dragon. And now Paul Dragon has been brought into the continuity. And in the book at one point, one of the bad guys merged the entire multiverse. So people have the memories of all of their other multiversal counterparts. So Paul Dragon shows up at Malcolm's door and he's like, hey, I'm your dad, but not really, but I have all your memories, so I'm basically your dad.
And
you're not my dad. Please leave.
Like, I'm not getting you a card.
Yeah. The fin on your head doesn't look right. Please leave.
Fucking wild. What you got, guys? You think we're talking about?
Handmaid's Tale is back, and it is going hard. As usual, so.
Handmaid's Tale is back and depressing as ever.
It's depressing, but it's moving.
Is that another? I wouldn't recommend it to anybody.
I mean, it's great, but maybe not for everyone.
Can't handle The Handmaid's Tale. I watched season one and I was like, no, thank you.
Yeah, I've seen just the clips and what I've heard people talking about. I'm like, I don't think I'm ever in a mood to watch this.
No. Yeah, it sounds like it's exceptionally well done, but just a fucking bummer.
Yeah.
Yeah. It feels like it happens in current day and it's like set in like New England and it's just like, okay, this is I don't want this in my life.
Oh, it's the story of Mahoney.
Yeah.
The Hand Mahoney's Tale.
What you got, Jose? What's up with the Jose Maid's Tale?
I started playing that. It's free on Xbox Game Pass. Jedi Fallen Order. Anybody?
Oh, yeah, that's a good one. Mary that's played that.
Yeah. No, it's pretty good. I fucking love it. This feels to me Arkham Knight, Arkham City, whatever the series. Like how when you play, you feel like you're Batman.
Right.
You play this, you feel Jedi. You're force pushing. Like I haven't unlocked all of his powers yet, so I can only push and wall run. And I can hold them.
The classic Jedi moves. Push, wall, run.
Yeah.
Push, wall, run, and hold your friends.
I can't pull them to me yet. But I think you unlock pull.
I don't know if it works on Xbox, but because PlayStation has the big light on the top of the controller, when you pick your lightsaber color, the controller turns that color.
Yeah, no, Xbox doesn't do that shit.
It's pretty fucking cool.
But do recommend if you like Arkham style game in the Star Wars universe. And it's fucking beautiful. Like there's some scenes that it's like, God damn, I want to take a picture of that. That's fucking nice.
Do you know who the actor is that plays the main character?
Yes. Shameless and Joker.
He was Joker on Gotham. Yeah.
Cameron Monaghan.
I don't know what happens to him because I'm still playing it, but I wouldn't mind. I mean, it'd be cool to see some of these game characters translate. You know what I mean? Like if he showed up on like Mandalorian or some shit. I mean, I don't know.
I was honestly hoping that it would be Cal that showed up
instead of Grogu
at the end of season two. I kind of
was expecting that because of the game mainly. I was like, oh shit. Well, if they're going to use him in the game, maybe they're going to like use him.
He's a real actor, you know, and the character looks like him anyway. It'd be pretty cool. I was really hoping it'd be him, but instead
it's
we got
probably just a matter of time.
Yeah,
I mean, but I would be cool if he showed up as a Jedi. I'm down. You know, again, no spoilers. I don't know what happens to him.
His story is cool. Like where they leave him, he could absolutely show up in something later for sure.
Nice, dig it.
Yeah, it could totally happen.
Well, do recommend.
Oh, shit. Speaking of video games, if you've got PlayStation, they're doing that Days of Play shit where they just give away free games in the summertime, in the springtime and whatever. So if you have PlayStation, you don't have the PlayStation Plus, whatever, just anybody who's got a PlayStation, you can download Horizon Zero Dawn for free, and I would definitely get on that if you haven't played it. It's an excellent
game. Oh, really? Shit.
Yeah. Excellent game. It's beautiful. It's wonderful. I would highly recommend it. Get on that. What you got, Mahoney?
The other thing you should get on is go download Fortnite and then come and play with us because we need some low-ranked people to get us some scrubs that we can just fucking torture.
Embarrass.
Yeah.
Yeah, we need some low-level players we can sandbag the Fortnite trios.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of Mahoney's...
We would like to, you know, we'll teach you how to play and in exchange we will fucking torment 97 other players.
One of Mahoney's favorite moves is if somebody is in a building with a door and they open the door, he will chuck a grenade in there, close the door, and just let them explode themselves.
Yep. It's amazing. Did that the other night. It's like something out of a cartoon. Like they come running, they open the door, in goes the grenade, door closes, and then you just see the smoke, and then they're just crawling around in there, like, ow. It's like, shouldn't have done that.
You should have chosen the window.
Yeah, the other night, me, Mary, and the Mahonies went on like a, it had to be a 4-game win streak in a row, which is just unheard of.
It's pretty great until the game is like, let's get you some better competition. And it's like, no, thank you. Oh, thanks. We're happy with the competition.
Or we get a little too cocky and we don't stay close together and we got that bloodlust and we go wandering a little too far from the group. That happens.
We don't even have bullets. We're just like, I got 10 bullets. I can take out this whole squad.
Wonderful. I did the other day. I was playing, and I was fishing because I was doing a lot of fish challenges, and I was getting bullets are coming by, and I was on the pier at Sweaty Sands, and I'm fishing, and this guy's way the fuck out at the island, the Coral Castle Island,
yeah,
and he's shooting me with a rifle from like forever away. All right, that's cool. You shoot that. I, however, have a purple bow, so he's shooting. I'm getting hit by like every 12th bullet, and I'm just taking my, I just line up my shot, headshot, exploded immediately, and it was like excellent shot. You killed from 500 meters away. I'm like, get your ass, I did. Like, why would you even like? I was fishing. He could have snuck up on me, but he was like, nah.
We I'm say a that all the time
from wherever away.
Sometimes these kids are just like, I gotta get this guy, and it's like, if you had just minded your business, everything would have been cool.
Fucking played himself, this kid.
Yep. I don't know what they're doing.
Let's call it. Next week, come back, we'll talk about...
Fuck you, Strawberry Shortcake.
Yeah. Fuck out of here, Strawberry Shortcake. Come back, we'll talk about chain restaurants next week. 10 p.m. Eastern, 9 p.m. Central at youtube.com/panelsonpages for Jason Nyes, Jose Guzman, Kelly Harris, and our good buddy Mahoney. I am the Lord Reverend Lee Rodriguez. I'll talk to you guys next week. Night. Love ya. Bye-bye.
Why you keep bugging us, you two?
You fucking Google-ass bitch. That's it. Show's over. We're done.
See you next Tuesday.